just saw a tweet. He might be out for a while.
Yeah, then I think that's what makes it interesting, I think, in terms of the point differential. Like you were saying, like in one of the Sixers group stage games, Joel, like, took a shot in, like, a blowout at the last second and made it. And the opposing team, I think it was – I forget which team it was. It might have been the Pistons or something. Mm. But they all started, like, coming at him and like trying to like cause a scuffle, and he was like no, like in his post game he's like, no, these points matter. It's not like I'm just doing it to be annoying, like I'm trying to get the point differential.
DeRozan was mad at the Raptors for doing the same thing.
Yeah,
like these guys are a lot of these guys don't get it.
It's crazy that the players don't know that. I mean, yeah. We're talking about how little we know about the in-season tournament. Yeah. How are you the best player on your team and you don't know what that point differential is going to determine who's in and who's out?
Especially
in the
terrible teams like the Bulls.
You
like,
should want to win.
Bulls
this.
And who was mad? The Pacers.
I think it was the Pistons.
The Bulls
who are
owned
four. Who are owned four and are officially out.
They should be so much better than they are. Like I would say on paper, the Pistons have as much talent as, maybe not that Chet's good now.
From the Rose Hill Gym on the campus of Fordham University, this is Fordham Women's Basketball on WFUV Sports. Today's match is between the Fordham Rams and the UMass Lowell Riverhawks. I'm Nick Guzman alongside Chris Carrino. And Chris, Fordham snapped a two-game losing streak by getting a much-needed 85 Georgian Court on Monday. Georgian Court were a winless D2 team, but what can they take away from that victory as Fordham gets ready to take on the Riverhawks in just a few minutes?
You know, Guz, in their first four games of the season, this Rams team really struggled to score, really kind of towing that marker between the 60-point line. But the Georgian Court game, more specifically, they really just tied in on key areas that they really wanted to improve on. Getting to the basket, getting wherever they wanted in real high-percentage shot situations. And then also on the perimeter, getting a lot of open threes and making them with consistency. That was the real key for this Fordham Ram team. Played with a real purpose, and they just look like a completely different team than the start of the season. Hopefully they can translate some of that success into today.
We got a chance to sit down with Fordham head coach Bridgette Mitchell just moments ago. Take a listen.
Nick Guzman here alongside Chris Carino with Fordham women's basketball coach Bridgette Mitchell. Coach, what were you most pleased with from your team's performance on Monday against Georgian Court?
I think that I was really pleased with how aggressive everyone was, right? Like hunting their shots, looking for their opportunities, and so that was really fun to see from an offensive perspective.
We talked about kind of the improvements on the offensive end before the Georgian Court game. And then in that Georgian Court game, I saw like a nice balance of getting inside, high percentage shots, things like that, really being physical, but also perimeter game, really getting, you know, players open on that 3-point line. Was that something you guys kind of focused on, kind of the balanced duality of that?
Yeah, it's been a real tough conversation of everyone has to hunt their shots, right? The difference between a good and a great shot. We want great shots, so that means sometimes you have to make the extra pass. Sometimes the great shot is yours, so you got to be ready to knock it down, and I think that's something that we did really well in that game.
Yeah, and then this kind of non-conference kind of portion of the schedule right now, what's the kind of importance you guys put on it when you kind of get to A-10, play time?
Yeah, this is all preparation, right? We talk about it all the time. We're going to win some games. We're going to lose some games. Some are going to be close. Some are going to be blowouts, right? Some you're going to face injuries, which we experienced before, right, in terms of people missing games, opportunity for other people to rise to the occasion. Right. And so all of these are just kind of hits and bruises that we're taking as we gear up for a competitive A-10 tournament.
And then lastly, was there a reason why Amy only played a handful of minutes on Monday?
No reason. She just, it was that game where her teammates, she could look to her teammates a little bit more to support.
All right. Thanks, Coach B.
Mm-hmm.
Mm-hmm. Whoa, whoa, whoa.
What's up, everyone? I'm Julia Moss, one of the hosts of WFUV's women's sports podcast, All In. Join us each week as we break down everything from the WNBA, women's collegiate sports, the NWSL, and so much more. We're also joined by recurring hosts including Maddie Bamonte, Taylor Massetta, Sam Bohr, and Annabelle Watson.
Damn.
All In is a production of WFUV Sports.
Welcome back inside the Rose Hill Gym. Nick Guzman here alongside Chris Carino. Fordham and UMass Lowell just moments away from tip-off here at the Rose Hill Gym. And Chris, big news for Fordham, Taylor Donaldson back after missing the last two games.
Yeah, you can just see her impact when she's not out there. I mean, obviously, people like Amy Hayford and Taya Davis, a lot of people really handling the load and kind of next man up kind of, you know, ideal kind of from this Fordham team. But really, her absence is kind of just one of the pivotal scorers, but also one of the pivotal leaders on this team. Definitely going to be nice to see her back today.
And she slots right back into Fordham's starting lineup alongside Matilda Flood, Miranda Nyborg, Taya Davis, and Amy Hayford. There are a couple players out for this Fordham Rams team. Kayla Harris will not play today. Neither will Nina Lee. So some post presence will be missing from Fordham, and Miranda Nyborg gets rewarded with the start with those players missing. But when you look at that starting five for Fordham, Donaldson, Hayford, Flood, Davis, Nyborg, who stands out to you?
I mean, it's a balanced starting five. A lot of people just doing their kind of role, really feeding into that, making the right play kind of mindset that Coach Bridget Mitchell was kind of talking about before the game. But Mandy McGurk, really one of those players that's really standing out to me. She obviously had a great game, and she's going to be coming off the bench today. But really just her efficiency behind the three-point line and really being able to depend on her in such, you know, high pace, really high intensity kind of moments when they're going in the fast court and when they're really just moving in transition. She's really important for this team, and I expect to see her make big minutes off the bench.
And on the UMass Lowell side of things, they're starting five. It's Abby Lindsay, Leilana Rodriguez, Maddie Rice, Sydney Watkins, and Alex Gitchenko for the UMass Lowell Riverhawks. Missing a second consecutive game is Millie Carrera, who is this team's leading scorer with 11 points. There's a handful of players out for this Riverhawks team, so they're a little bit shorthanded. But Chris, this is a UMass Lowell team that's 0-5 on the season, but they've hung tough with Boston University and with Lemoyne. Those are both just 2-point losses, but 0-5 looking for their first win coming here to Rose Hill.
Yeah, this UMass Lowell team, they're in a bit of a transitional period now when it comes to the program. Head coach Denise King came in 2 years ago. Ever since then, they've had two conference tournament berths, two losses in the quarterfinals. Definitely a bit of a difference from where their program had been before she had gotten there. Obviously, she had been with the program since 2018, getting that job in 2021. But this year, we kind of talked about it before the game today, a lot of new faces, a lot of freshmen, a very young team for this Riverhawks squad. But overall, it's a lot of inexperience around the court. They need their players to really step up into leadership roles, even players who haven't played that much, and maybe, you know, get some sort of, at least some sort of success today. Maybe not with maybe one, maybe their hardest challenge up to date on their schedule, but maybe just a moral victory would be nice for the Riverhawks today.
And for Fordham, this is their second America East opponent of the season. They snapped their two-game losing streak after losing to UMiami and Manhattan College by beating Georgian Court on Monday. Players were able to go home for the holiday on Thursday for Thanksgiving, and now regrouping as non-conference schedule really is coming to a head here as we're really getting close to conference play. In early December, Fordham will open up their conference schedule against Duquesne. So what's important, Chris, for the Rams to get out of these couple last non-conference games they have before stuff really starts to matter?
Yeah, we talked about it with head coach Bridget Mitchell before the game. Kind of just, it's a trial run. It's a bit of a dress rehearsal for this Fordham team. Obviously, the A-10 schedule and conference play in general is really where it matters kind of in the season. But these kind of games, especially when it may be a lower level of competition than you may be used to in the conference, it's really just trial runs and working out the kinks of the season.
And for Fordham, today is Amy Hayford, I think, is another storyline to talk about, Chris, because she only played 6 minutes against Georgian Court.
Yeah.
It's a blowout, so you don't want to read too much into that. She's back in the starting lineup again today. She's been for one of their most effective players in terms of scoring.
Yeah, we know from that experience from her time in Pittsburgh that she's definitely someone with a unique experience, unique perspective on this Fordham roster that, again, Fordham as well as a young team, just kind of having a leadership role on that squad. The 6 minutes she played against Georgian Court, I think, is more to say about the competition and less to say about her, but definitely expect her to have big minutes today and really be contributing in the middle of most of their offensive and defensive schemes.
And there were other players who contributed coming off the bench for this Fordham team in the last game against Georgian Court. Cassidy Mahaney pretty much had a career game, made three-pointers as a freshman, able to come into the rotation. And with Nina Lee out, you know, there's going to be more opportunity for those kinds of players to step in as well. We're just about ready to get underway here at the Rose Hill Gym. Fordham wearing white, UMass Lowell in blue. The Rams attacking from right to left. UMass Lowell from left to right. Miranda Nyborg against Alex Gitchenko on the tip-off. 10 minutes on the clock in this first quarter. Nyborg sporting a face mask to protect her nose. And we are just about ready to get underway. Here we go. Nyborg wins the tip ahead to Matilda Flood in the front court for Fordham. and Rams will get the first offensive possession of the game. Taya Davis commanding the offense at the Fordham logo. Up top to the far side wing for Taylor Donaldson. Donaldson first game back after missing two. Donaldson into the lane. Nyborg, the mid-range jumper from behind the free throw line, and she drains it. 2-0 Fordham, 20 seconds in.
That ability from Nyborg to stretch the floor there, so important for the efficiency of this offense.
And immediately backcourt pressure from the Rams in the form of Taya Davis and Amy Hayford. But they'll settle it down with Leilana Rodriguez at the Block F logo. Gitchenko, and now up top again for Madi Rice straight away. Rice gets inside, hands off for Rodriguez. She'll pull a three. That's no good off the side of the backboard. Offensive rebound gathered there by Madi Rice underneath. She stepped on the baseline. That's a turnover, Fordham basketball.
Yeah, Matilda Flood, another person that really standed out last game. That ferocity on the defensive end there is the reason for the turnover.
Taya Davis will carry ahead for the Rams. 50 seconds elapsed here in the first quarter. Fordham on top of UMass Lowell early, 2-0. Taylor Donaldson with the ball on the far side wing in front of the UMass bench. Amy Hayford now to the left side wing, hands off for Taya Davis. Davis gets the lane, lost control. They go to the ground with it, stolen away by UMass Lowell, and they'll go back the other way. Rodriguez leads the break. Sydney Watkins now on the right wing. Pass out to the far side, Abby Lindsay. Lindsay gets to the baseline. Lindsay throws one up. Nyborg right there, and it'll be Fordham basketball as the ball went out on the baseline.
Yeah, Goose, great defense on both possessions there, but that possession specifically, the way Nyborg was kind of staying straight up inside, not getting the foul. Fouls have been a problem for this team. It's great to see them trying to avoid it.
Donaldson again will start the offense on that far wing. She gets a screen from Nyborg straight away now for Amy Hayford. Hayford cuts the basket, lost control, and a turnover. Coming back the other way, it's Sydney Watkins with numbers for UMass Lowell. Watkins gets the basket against Nyborg. Her shot rims out, and Nyborg can grab the board. Nice. Amy Hayford pushing the tempo back the other way. Hayford gets to the basket. Hayford's layup no good. Rebound UMass Lowell. Abby Lindsay streaking down the far side into the front court. And Lindsay will hand back for Watkins to settle down in front of the Fordham bench. Gitchenko straight away to the near side wing for Leilana Rodriguez. Watched closely by Amy Hayford. Rodriguez into the post for Gitchenko with Taylor Donaldson defending, and Donaldson gets whistled for the foul.
Yeah, Donaldson just coming back, as we said, off that injury. This team wants to stay out of foul trouble. Foul's definitely a bit of a problem. Georgian court, obviously not that much of a competitive affair, but definitely something you would want to nitpick in their defensive play. It's just the kind of fouls, especially early in the game, you don't want to pile them up.
UMass Lowell will inbound underneath as Mandy McGurk has entered the game for Fordham. That's a five-second call. It's a turnover. Fordham doing great defense there on the inbounds, and they'll take over.
Another testament to just the ferocity and the intenseness they're playing on the defensive end right now, Goose.
But it's McGurk in for Hayford for the Rams, their first substitution of the game, as Taya Davis enters the front court, out to the far side wing for Taylor Donaldson. Donaldson will pull up from mid-range. Her jumper's perfect. 4-0 Fordham with 7:38 to go in the first quarter. In the backcourt again, more pressure this time in the form of Matilda Flood, watching Sydney Watkins. Crossing the timeline, Leilana Rodriguez just gets it to Watkins. A double team for Fordham on the near side. Gitchenko able to get to the baseline. Her shot off front rim, no good. Matilda Flood couldn't secure the rebound. Last touch off UMass Lowell, though. Fordham will get it.
Every kind of scrum or anything like that, any hard-working play, you always see number one in white there, Matilda Flood. She seems to be in the middle of everything, defensively and offensively.
Taya Davis carrying ahead once again for Fordham. Rose Nelson and Kayla Berry waiting at halfway to enter the game. Donaldson on the far side. Back for Taya Davis up top. Davis crossed over to her left hand. The feed inside for Nyborg in the paint. Nyborg kicks it out. Matilda Flood open for three. That's an air ball. And UMass Lowell will take over possession.
I don't like the air ball there, Goose, but getting the shot from the three-point line with nobody around her and spreading the floor that way is definitely a good sign for the Fordham offense.
And Rose Nelson and Kayla Berry will check in for Fordham. Miranda Nyborg, Matilda Flood will take a seat on the bench as carrying ahead is Leilana Rodriguez for UMass Lowell. Hands off for Gitchenko on the near side wing. Back up top again for Madi Rice. Rice spinning against Kayla Berry, forced to pick up her dribble. Gitchenko in the lane, pass behind Rodriguez, and that's a turnover.
Yeah, we talked to Coach before the game, kind of stressing turnovers as maybe being an issue for this Fordham team, trying to limit themselves to under 16, but it seems like UMass Lowell is having that similar kind of problem right now.
Yeah, 16 was the number that Coach B brought up for Fordham, and you know, when you're turning the ball over 20 times a game, it's hard to cut that number way down to a low number, but 16 was the benchmark.
Trying to be a little more realistic.
That Coach B wants to get to in this game. It's Taylor Donaldson in the front court. She'll pull up from mid-range on the far side. Another mid-range jumper from Donaldson, and it's perfect again.
And it's the second time she's almost hit that exact same shot. Definitely an important piece to have in her game, that mid-range jumper.
6-0 Rams with 6:22 to go. More pressure from Fordham. UMass able to get the ball into the front court, and Sydney Watkins will settle things down at the Block F logo. Swung to the near side for Rodriguez. Rodriguez gets the basket, spins. Her shot no good off front rim. Donaldson can break the other way for the Rams. Donaldson gets right to the basket. The lefty layup, no good. Kayla Berry streaks in for the rebound. Back up top again for Taya Davis. Davis again driving to Donaldson. She'll pull a three off back rim, no good. Kayla Berry the rebound again, and Taya Davis can go back and get inside and finish again. Taya Davis, it's 8-0 Rams.
The tough move, that's what she can do when she's out there. She can go and take it to the rack, or she can make a great pass as well.
Two offensive boards on that sequence for Kayla Berry. It's 8-0 Fordham with 5:35 to go in the first quarter. Pass up ahead for Maddie Rice for UMass Lowell. The pull-up jumper from Abby Lindsay off back rim from the mid-range, no good. Mandy McGurk grabs the board and will look to push the tempo once again for the Rams. McGurk, crossover, the step back jump from mid-range, off front rim, but she gets the bounce. 10-0 Fordham, and UMass Lowell will take a timeout with 5:19 to go in the first quarter. It's 10-0 Fordham. You're listening to Fordham Women's Basketball on WFUV Sports.
The one-on-one scoreboard.
Hey everyone, I'm Will Grant.
And I'm Chris Percy-Einen.
And we're two of the hosts for WFUV's very own basketball podcast, Pick and Pod.
Tune in weekly for updates and our takes on the latest around the NBA, as well as exclusive insight from our very own Knicks and Nets beat reporters.
We'll have you covered on everything from all of the NBA's latest drama we know and love,
to debating all year long which team will get to lift that golden Larry O'Brien in June.
So don't miss a beat from the hardwood on WFUV's Pick and Pod.
Welcome back inside the Rose Hill Gym. Fordham with an early 10-0 lead over UMass Lowell with 5:19 to go in this first quarter. Nick Guzman here alongside Chris Carrino. And really a perfect start for Fordham. And a lot of different players doing it, Chris.
Yeah, Mandy McGurk, she just scored going into the timeout. I talked about her. You asked me to give you a starter. I thought it would be impactful. I gave you a girl on the bench. I'm just a contrarian in that way, Goose. But I genuinely think she has such a massive impact for this Fordham team. Saw it just there on the break. They're running fast with speed in transition. And she can just pull up, take that mid-range jumper. So valuable for this Fordham team. But if we're going to talk about valuability and this Fordham team, does not go farther than Taylor Donaldson. She's been absolutely fantastic today. You can see just how her talent and her skill on the offensive end is missed when she's back. It's a night and day difference from previous games.
And Donaldson hasn't shot particularly efficiently so far this season, but she's just another player in that lineup that's not afraid to create a shot for herself, which is something you need to open up the floor for other players.
Yeah, she's just an impact player, and you can even see it at her time at New Mexico State as well. You just watch her play on the floor, and just one of those people where you just know she has game, you know she can play, and she really separates herself from everyone else that's on the floor with her.
So it's 10-0 Rams with 5:19 to go in this first quarter. Donaldson has four. Nyborg with two. Taya Davis with two. And then Mandy McGurk also with two. For McGurk, it was a season high of 15 points in the last game against Georgian Court. She played 29 minutes after really struggling against Manhattan and then against Miami. It was a bounce back game for a lot of Fordham players trying to continue that momentum into today.
Yeah, and that three-point percentage, I think, is a big testament to the similar shots that Matilda Flood is getting today, Taylor Donaldson, and Mandy McGurk. A lot of those open three-point looks around the perimeter, kind of shading all the attention away from it by kind of pushing everything inside and leaving things open on the perimeter, getting those high-volume shots where you really are open and you have a good shot of it. That's how you have efficient three-point shooting.
They were just about set to come out of this timeout. It's interesting when you look at the UMass Lowell side of things and how their season's gone so far. So many games on the road for them. They've played just one home game this season against Lemoyne, and 8 of their first 9 games, even after today, are on the road. So yeah, it's a tough non-conference schedule for them, which might explain why they're 0-5.
Yeah, and I felt like the Lemoyne game was theirs to lose. They went up double digits going into halftime. I really thought that's a game they could have won, gotten rid of that zero in their win column for the season so far. But yeah, just staying away from home this much can't be easy, especially this early in the season.
So coming out of the timeout, UMass Lowell will inbound in the backcourt, and Fordham will look to apply pressure immediately. Taylor Donaldson does just that. Donaldson pressuring Sydney Watkins in the backcourt. Now Matilda Flood, they just get it across the timeline to Getchenko. And now Ross all in one motion just on the court. That's off front rim, no good, but a rebound down low by Getchenko. And Sydney Watkins can settle things down for UMass. Watkins, pass off there for Abby Lindsay on this near side wing. Straight up top again for Gitchenko. To the far side there for Watkins. Into the paint, Gitchenko, stripped by Flood. Can they get to it before it gets to the baseline? They can, it's a steal. Matilda Flood back the other way for the Rams. Flood, hands off for Amy Hayford, who will pause at the logo and command the Fordham offense. Hayford circles left around the perimeter. Pass straight away for Mandy McGurk. McGurk to the far wing for Flood. Flood gets the lane all the way. Flood can't finish with the underhand layup and a rebound by Gitchenko. Watkins carries across the timeline for UMass Lowell. Watkins thrown into Rain Durant just on the court. Durant, a tough shot, no good against Rose Nelson. Another rebound for Flood. And again, Fordham pushing the tempo. Flood, beautiful bounce pass in the lane. Mandy McGurk with the finish. 12-0 Rams with 4:05 to go in the first quarter.
More fast play from this Rams team, converting good defense into transition fast offense has really been the key so far.
Gabby Ross into the front court for UMass Lowell. Watched closely by Mandy McGurk. The Riverhawks just having trouble getting their offense set up here. Ross, let's go all the way, feeds it out to the near corner. That's a three off front rim, no good from Abby Lindsay. And another rebound for the Rams. McGurk will look to push it again. The long pass ahead for Hayford, who will now settle things down up top for the Rams. Hayford for Flood, hands off back for Hayford on his near side. Hayford gets all the way to the baseline. Her underhand layup, no good, and a rebound there from Lindsay. Lindsay into the front court. Flood and Hayford met her right there, and the Rams will get whistled for a foul. It's Flood.
Flood, again, always in the mix, even a few possessions earlier when she gets the defensive stop on the baseline, converts that into a dribble handoff where they can start a more, you know, half-court, really set-up offense. It just translates good defense into good offense, and they're doing it really well this afternoon.
Yeah, Flood leads this Fordham team, averaging 2.4 steals a game, 12 total. Player that does it all for Coach Bridgette Mitchell. UMass Lowell inbound in front of the Fordham bench. Off the inbound, the corner jumper. That's perfect from Abby Lindsay. And UMass Lowell are on the board. That's a two from the corner. It's 12-2.
Yeah, she got that one to go. She's definitely not afraid of shooting them. She shot a couple so far. Finally gets one to go.
For Fordham in the front court, it's Mandy McGurk on the far side wing. McGurk uses the screen from Nelson back towards the middle. Now on the near side wing for Taya Davis. Davis gets to the lane, pauses at the free throw line. Flood now on the far side. Circles inside, up top of the perimeter for Mandy McGurk. Straight away, Amy Hayford. Hayford will step into a three. A tough shot off back rim, no good. And a rebound underneath for Rain Durant. Back the other way for UMass Lowell. It's Tasha Lima, and now into the post here for Gitchenko. A loose ball, they go to the ground with it. And Flood tied up with Gitchenko. It's a jump ball. Possession arrow in the direction of UMass Lowell. They'll keep it. But again, Matilda Flood all over the place.
Yeah, and those long possessions on the offensive end for this Fordham team is just a testament to how far they're going to try and make the best play in their situation. And it brings off those long, prolonged possessions.
Sydney Watkins to inbound on the baseline. Gets it into Tasha Lima. First time on the court today. Leilana Rodriguez up top for UMass Lowell. McGurk with the steal as they tried to feed it into the post. McGurk now with some pressure in the backcourt. They'll get it ahead for Amy Hayford to cross the timeline. Hayford will pull up from mid-range, off back rim and out, and a rebound there for Sydney Watkins. Watkins running against Mandy McGurk. Watkins to the baseline, pass out to the far side wing, couldn't be corralled. And another turnover for UMass Lowell.
Yeah, the turnover is just becoming a big problem for this Riverhawk team. I think McGurk and Flood, to their credit, have really taken advantage of every even small mistake that this Riverhawk team has made so far.
So it's 12-2 Fordham with 2:05 to go in the first quarter. Taya Davis at the Fordham logo. Hands off for Miranda Nyborg at the top of the key. Nyborg bounce pass in the lane for Hayford. Hayford, the tough righty shot, no good. And a rebound there from Tasha Lima, who can carry ahead for UMass Lowell. To the far side for Sydney Watkins. Watkins down at the top of the key to the near side for Rodriguez. Watkins again to the baseline. Her pass inside, intercepted again by Flood. Fordham have numbers the other way. It's Hayford. Hayford all the way. Righty underhand layup, no good. Fordham get the offensive board, though. Mandy McGurk's open for three on the near side. Off front rim and out. And a rebound there from Tasha Lima. Lima ahead to the far side win for Leilana Rodriguez. With a minute 20 to go in the first quarter, still 12-2 Rams. Rodriguez circles towards the middle. This is Worley now, pass inside, and an offensive foul against Rain Durant. Taya Davis drew it,
Yeah, it's just selfless defense. I mean, I think the Charge is the biggest testament to selfless defense. They're really taking advantage of every UMass Lowell mistake. They're definitely playing a sloppy game. It's not all on Fordham. It's definitely partly on UMass Lowell as well. But this Fordham team is playing a clean game. They really need to transition this great defense into more efficient offense. Missing a lot of shots right now.
Davis ahead into the front court for Fordham to the far side wing for Amy Hayford. Hayford circles towards the middle, now gets to the lane, picks up her dribble. Miranda Nyborg's mid-range jumper is blocked away. It's loose in the paint. Nyborg and Hayford on the ground wrestling for it. And a jump ball is the call. Possession arrow will stay here with the Rams. They have 9 seconds to shoot. 52.8 to go in the quarter.
Yeah, this Riverhawk team, they've struggled to score all season long. Only two games this season where they've had more than 45 points. So you could see it right now, the discrepancy they have on the offensive end. Only 2 points in this entire quarter so far.
Davis will inbound on the baseline to this near side corner for Donaldson. She couldn't corral it, and it's a turnover. The other way, it's Leilana Rodriguez, the two-on-one. Rodriguez feeds to Abby Lindsay, who goes up for the layup and the finish. 12-4 Rams with 41.4 to go in the first quarter. As the pass deflected in the backcourt, but Fordham will keep it. Taya Davis now with 38 to go. Davis across the timeline for Matilda Flood. Miranda Nyborg at the top of the key has it. Nyborg hands off for Amy Hayford up top. She fakes the three, gets the basket. Hayford, the righty layup's perfect. 14-4 Rams with 20 seconds to go. And the shot clock turned off in this first quarter. Rodriguez up ahead for UMass Lowell. Commanding the offense with 10 seconds to go in the quarter. Rodriguez still hands off for Durant on the far side. They need to get a shot up with 3 seconds in the lane. That's blocked away. Back the other way is Hayford, Fordham, and Hayford can't get a shot off going back the other way. So that will end the first quarter here at the Rose Hill Gym. It's Fordham 14, UMass Lowell 4. And we'll send it back to our Rose Hill studios for the one-on-one scoreboard with Madi Dembele.
The one-on-one scoreboard.
Come fly with me, Madi Dembele, as I take you around the world of sports. Staying in the A-10, the Charlotte 49ers handling business as they lead the George Washington Revolutionaries 25-16. As we expand further to women's basketball as a whole, the Lady Bruins look to remain perfect in their second of their back-to-back against the Purple Eagles as UCLA takes on the Niagara Purple Eagles. Paradise Jam. Number 10 North Carolina State takes on number 3 ranked Colorado. Basketball, this is not football. As we cross over to the men's side, the Loyola Maryland Greyhounds and the Missouri Tigers do battle with the Tigers up 4. As we look further to NBA play, for the one-on-one scoreboard, I'm Madi Dembele.
Inside the Rose Hill Gym, Fordham on top of UMass Lowell, 14-4 as we get ready to start the second quarter. Nick Guzman here alongside Chris Carrino. And Chris, in that first quarter, just 4 points for UMass Lowell, but Fordham also only shooting 36% and really at some time struggling to knock down their shots.
Yeah, that was a point I was going to kind of try and make. You obviously see the scoreboard, it's 14-4, but not a ton of efficiency coming from this Fordham offense. It's a lot of great defense, tenacious, and just aggressive defense on that side of the ball, and then it transitioning well into the offensive end. And they can kind of channel some of that energy they have on the defensive end, bring it to the offensive end, and kind of stick with that same mindset of just trying to make the right play. I feel like sometimes when they try to make the right play on possessions, they really kind of get themselves muddied up, and they kind of confuse themselves almost. They could just really keep it simple, just try and make the right play and the best play for the situation. I think they'll really see an improvement on the offensive side of the ball.
And we know Fordham's a team that wants to play fast, but this game has been exceptionally fast on both sides. But Fordham really doing their thing of causing chaos on defense with the pressing and the double teams to force those turnovers and keep UMass Lowell off the board.
Yeah, the fast transition play is really coming from a lot of Riverhawk mistakes. This UMass Lowell team is turning over the ball a lot, and this Fordham defense, you know, with their respect, they're making a lot of plays on their own. A lot of that is turning the other way, really creating this, making this into a bit of a marathon, just them running back and forth, a lot of transition play. Fordham kind of limiting their turnovers, not as bad as maybe they'd hoped for, probably a little better than they would hope for, But just more of that transition play will probably be seen unless this UMass Lowell team can really clean it up on the offensive side of the ball.
Yeah, the Rams are already forced 8 turnovers for UMass Lowell. Fordham have turned the ball over 3 times so far. As we're ready to start the second quarter here at the Rose Hill Gym. Fordham on top of UMass Lowell, 14-4. UMass Lowell, an America East team, 0-5 so far this season. They were 5-22 last year, but miraculously they won their last 3 games of the season to sneak into the America East tournament. They lost in the first round, but after only winning 5 games all season, it was a miraculous feat to even get into that tournament.
Yeah, I mean, they're going into their pre-poll for their conference, the American East, they have the least amount of points. They're really getting doubted this season. They want to prove a lot of people wrong this season.
Leilana Rodriguez has it for UMass Lowell at the start of this second quarter. Rodriguez with it up top. Out to the far side for Tasha Lima. Lima inside, back out for Rodriguez. She'll try the 3, and she knocks it down. 14-7 Rams, 20 seconds gone here in the second quarter. Matilda Flood in the back over Fordham. Now Taya Davis on this near side. Flood will cross the timeline straight away. And now Davis will settle things down for the Fordham offense. Davis circles to this near side wing. Up top, this is Taylor Donaldson for Fordham. Donaldson to the corner for Amy Hayford. She'll try the 3. She knocks it down. Amy Hayford for 3. 17-7 Rams.
Getting open threes and making them, that's going to be the name of the game on the offensive end for this Fordham Ram team this afternoon.
It's Tasha Lima in the backcourt for UMass Lowell. Gets to the Block F logo. Now circles to the near side wing. Hands off for Rodriguez. Rodriguez straight away. Out to the far side there for Sydney Watkins. Watkins, pass inside for Durant. Hands off for Lima, still on the perimeter, to Durant in the post, and a whistle and a foul on the entry pass. And UMass Lowell will keep possession.
Yeah, it's Amy Hayford's first foul. Doesn't seem to be too much of a worry. They haven't really gotten themselves in much foul trouble yet, but it can really become an issue once you start stacking them together.
Lima in the near side corner off the inbounds. Back towards the middle on the perimeter. Lima. Still looking for an option. Out to the far side there for Rodriguez. Rodriguez, Taya Davis got a hand on it. Now a wild shot there from Worley and a foul called against Nyborg.
Yeah, it seemed like Miranda Nyborg was straight up there. Very vertical. Didn't really see anything that would entail a foul. But she got lucky on a, you know, earlier in the game in the first quarter, a similar play. So, you know, you're eventually going to get called for the foul there.
So Worley will go to the free throw line for UMass Lowell. First one rolls in off front rim, 17-8 Rams. Worley, one of these freshmen who's gotten a lot of playing time for this UMass Lowell team.
Yeah,
in Philadelphia.
As we said before the game, this is a young UMass team, not even when it comes to age, but just experience in general. A lot of players that haven't played a lot of games together. But this UMass Lowell team is sticking around. The scoreboard could look worse than it is. It's only an 8-point game right now.
17-9 Fordham with 8:30 to go in the second quarter. And in the front court, Miranda Nyborg has it in the mid-range. Back out up top for Taya Davis. Davis to the corner for Donaldson, to the post for Nyborg, to the near side wing for Donaldson. Donaldson gets to the baseline. Again out to the far side for Hayford. Her 3's no good off back iron. And a rebound there from Watkins and a foul called against Matilda Flood.
Yeah, that's going to be your second foul. Definitely not fouls you want. Really pretty possession offensively between Donaldson and Amy Hayford in both corners, kind of alternating and really trying to get the best open shot around that perimeter, but just couldn't get it to fall.
Kayla Berry will check into the game for Fordham as Matilda Flood will sit down after picking up that foul. This is Leilana Rodriguez, now Watkins on the near side wing. Rodriguez up top. They tried to do the handoff. It's stolen away by Amy Hayford. Hayford going back the other way one-on-one. Hayford gets inside, can't finish. Kayla Berry's right there to clean up. 19-9 Fordham.
That strong play from Amy Hayford in transition, as I've been saying all game and harping on, translating good defense into good offense.
Tasha Lima has it on this near side wing for UMass Lowell as they can settle things down at the logo here through Sydney Watkins. Out to the far side for Worley. Worley hands off on the perimeter there for Rodriguez. Rodriguez from mid-range, no good. Durant fighting for the rebound. It comes to Donaldson, though, and Taylor Donaldson can break back the other way for Fordham. Donaldson into the near side wing, into the post for Miranda Nyborg. Nyborg to the baseline, goes up with it and gets fouled. Miranda Nyborg will shoot 2.
impressive stuff from Nyborg. Obviously, Nyborg not really receiving this many minutes, a lot of injuries, so she's getting her opportunity this afternoon, and she's making the most of it, really making that presence felt down and low, as I said, kind of with my interview with Coach before the game, kind of talking about that duality of interior play, getting those high-percentage shots inside, and also getting those open shots around the perimeter.
Nyborg's first free throw swishes home, 29 Rams. But when you have Mina Lee, who's usually your starting center, out, and then also Kayla Harris, who would play some key minutes, Brandon Nyborg steps into a bigger role.
Yeah, and she's doing it well.
Second free throw, perfect as well. It's 21-9 Rams with 7:18 to go in the second quarter. More pressure from Fordham in the backcourt. They're able to get it ahead, though, to Abby Lindsay. Lindsay goes all the way and finishes with the right hand. Taya Davis avoids the UMass defender and gets to the front court. Davis streaking now to this near side corner for Taylor Donaldson. Donaldson will fade away from the mid-range off front rim, bounces out, and then Donaldson gets called for the foul on the loose ball.
Yeah, it's definitely, again, not a foul that you want. Similar to the Matilda Flood foul that got her on the bench earlier. Just not fouls, especially coming out of a defensive rebound that you really want to commit. They need to be impactful and important fouls.
And just as Flood did after her backcourt foul, Donaldson will check out as well. Mandy McGurk back into the game for the Rams. Tasha Lima in the backcourt, watched closely by McGurk. Lima will escape up this near side and settle things down up top for UMass Lowell. Bounce pass to the far side wing for Sydney Watkins. Watkins watched closely by Nyborg and by Hayford. Kayla Berry read that perfectly. Last touch off Berry, they say.
Kayla Berry working hard defensively.
And UMass Lowell will keep it barely, but good anticipation from Berry, something we've seen in the last two games. She's stepped into a more pronounced role with some absences in this Fordham rotation.
Even the trailing offensive rebound and putback off the Amy Hayford miss on the free throw going through on fast break.
And on the inbound, it's another five-second call. Watkins couldn't find an open teammate. Fordham will take over.
Well, what I was going to say was Kayla Berry, who's standing right in front of us, her putback on that Amy Hayford layup in transition earlier, along with the tenacious defense on the other side of the ball, she's really making this kind of time she's getting and crevicing into the game very valuable.
So another turnover forced by the Rams from their pressure on defense. Taya Davis enters the front court on the far side. Gets the screen from Nyborg at the free throw line. Bounce pass to the near side wing for Mandy McGurk. McGurk back towards the middle to the far side wing for Amy Hayford. Tried to enter the post to Nyborg. That pass intercepted by Sydney Watkins. Watkins the other way. The three from Rodriguez off the side of the rim, nowhere close. Amy Hayford leading the transition break the other way for Fordham. Hayford on the far side wing. For Taya Davis up top with 6:10 to go in the second quarter, 21-11 Rams. Davis, McGurk on the near side wing. McGurk gets to the middle, tried to feed Berry in the paint. That pass deflected, another turnover for Fordham. And Leilana Rodriguez back the other way for UMass Lowell. Lindsay feeds the post there for Worley. Worley down low. That shot no good. Nyborg right there, stuck on the baseline. Another wild shot, and finally a foul called. Going to the free throw line is Sidney Coombs. Yeah, senior forward from New Market, New Hampshire.
Worley was trying to use the mismatch on McGurk down and low to kind of almost bully her to the rim, but right behind her was a Miranda Nyborg. She's never too far away on the defensive end.
Sidney Coombs in her fifth year for UMass Lowell, played 55 games across those five seasons. Started three games this season, averaging just 1.6 points per game, but she'll get a chance here from the free throw line after getting fouled underneath. Coombs' first free throw is good. 21-12 Rams, 5:49 to play in this second quarter.
Amy Hayford and Taylor Donaldson almost overshadow Taya Davis, but Taya Davis, again, so valuable to this team, especially when they have a few women in foul trouble on the bench. She really steps up into her role.
Second free throw rattled home for Coombs. Amy Hayford back the other way for Fordham in the front court. Hands off for Taya Davis up top. Davis will look for an option on offense. Davis to Hayford on the far side wing. Using a screen from Matilda Flood, gets inside. Now Davis gets to the middle, into the paint, to this near side wing for Mandy McGurk up top. McGurk in the mid-range, a fadeaway jumper off back rim, clanks out. McGurk gets her own rebound. She puts it up again and puts it in.
It's just a show to how she plays the game, following up her own offensive rebound and putting it in. Just real tenacious stuff.
23-13 Rams with 5:05 to go in the second quarter. This is Lindsay for UMass Lowell on the near side wing. Lindsay for Coombs up top. Coombs the handoff there for Watkins, watched closely by Rose Nelson. Worley into the post for Coombs.
Coombs with the left hand. Beautiful post move. It's 23-15.
Can't play better defense than that. Just offense beats defense every time.
Taya Davis again carrying ahead for Fordham on the far side. Davis into the front court. Davis gets the lane. The wild shot there. No good off the top of the backboard. And a rebound for UMass Lowell. Worley leading the break 2-on-1. Worley flips it up with her right hand. Off back rim, no good. And the rebound comes to Taya Davis. We'll slow things down here with 4:25 to go in the second quarter.
Yeah, Taya Davis just wanting to kind of control the pace of play here a little bit. Coach is going to take a timeout for Fordham.
Fordham head coach Bridgette Mitchell calls a timeout with 4:22 to go in the second quarter. It's Fordham 23, UMass Lowell 15. You're listening to Fordham Women's Basketball on WFUV Sports.
How's it going, everybody? I'm Lou Orlando.
And I'm Colin Loughran.
And we're two of your main hosts for WFUV Sports' NHL podcast, 5-on-3.
We'll keep you updated on the Rangers, Islanders, Devils, and of course, the Stanley Cup Final.
Home ice for all things NHL, 5-on-3.
Back here inside the Rose Hill Gym with 4:22 to play in the second quarter. Fordham on top of UMass Lowell, 23-15. Seemed like early when UMass Lowell really struggling to score, Chris, that this might get out of hand pretty fast, but they've hung tough here in the second quarter.
Yeah, the pace of play for this Riverhawk team really impressed me coming out the last 3 or 4 minutes, turning defensive, you know, great plays defensively, but also kind of mishaps that have happened on the Fordham offensive side of the ball, turning it the other way and taking advantage of it on the offensive side of the ball. We know Fordham wanted to come out running back and forth in that transitional play. I think this UMass Lowell team is kind of taking a page out of their opponent's book, really starting to show efficiency on that offensive side of the ball.
Yeah. On the Fordham side of things, there's 7 personal f2 so far against the Rams. You got 2 against Nyborg, 2 against Donaldson, 2 against Flood. So not ideal, especially when a lot of those fouls are happening in the backcourt when you feel like Fordham could just retreat and get set up on defense.
Yeah, and those pieces that you just said, those players, they're important pieces for this Fordham team. They really are a part of the engine that makes this Fordham team go. 2 fouls is okay. I'm not getting extremely nervous over 2 fouls. If they get that 3rd foul, especially before halftime's over in the next 4 minutes and change before we go in for halftime, that's where I'd start to get a little worried. That's when you really got to start playing conservatively on the defensive end.
But for someone like Matilda Flood, it is part of her game being that aggressive on defense, trying to get those steals. So you live with some of those fouls. Here with 4:22 to go in the second quarter, it's Fordham 23, UMass Lowell 15. For Fordham, you wouldn't think conference play is coming up, but it is coming up. They'll host St. Peter's University on Tuesday, followed by a home tilt against the University of Maine on Saturday, December 2nd. And after that, on Tuesday, December 5th, it's Fordham's first Atlantic 10 game of the season. That's away against Duquesne University. And it looks like when you look at the non-conference schedule at the start of the season that it just goes on and on forever and ever, but it really doesn't. And now it's sort of getting towards crunch time for this Fordham team.
Yeah, we talked about it before the game. We talked about it during the game as well. This non-conference portion of the schedule, so important for just trying to get to almost know your team. Obviously, this Fordham team, a lot of new faces, a lot of different faces. A ton of these lineups haven't really played a ton of minutes together. Just developing those minutes, developing some of that experience, and really just kind of gaining a liking for each other as a team, as a unit. That's really what this non-conference portion of the schedule is for. And we both know this 8-10 women's kind of gauntlet they're going to have to run through will be difficult for this Rams team. But games like this, success like this, especially a good first half that they maybe want to score a little bit more in, this is where it's really important, kind of building that confidence for the 8-10 schedule.
Coming out of the timeout, Taya Davis has it for Fordham into the front court. With 4:15 to go in the second quarter, Davis up top, hands off for Matilda Flood on the left side wing. Flood will step into a mid-range jumper, off front rim, bounces out. Flood scrambling for the offensive board. She gets it.
Wow.
She heaves it back up top for Mandy McGurk to reset the offense. More hustle play from Flood as Davis now, Flood again on that far side wing. Flood to the baseline. Flood, a tough shot. A lot of contact, no call. Back the other way comes Leilana Rodriguez to Lima, and she stepped on the sideline. That's a turnover. Tasha Lima for UMass Lowell.
Yeah, Matilda Flood, I mean, I like that she didn't make any sort of retribution foul after that, because I do think on the baseline there she did get fouled. Keeping her cool, keeping her composure, that's what's going to keep her in the game and keep her out of foul trouble.
Taya Davis across halfway for the Rams. Now Flood straight away. Rose Nelson at the top of the key has it for Fordham. Nelson makes a move with her left hand, gets the basket. Nelson, tough layup, bounces out, and UMass Lowell can go back the other way. Sydney Watkins for the Riverhawks, commanding up top. Watkins out to the far side there for Lima. Lima makes a move towards the baseline, puts up the righty layup, and that's good. Kasha Lima knocks it down. It's 23-17 with 3:10 to go in the second quarter.
Yeah, this Riverhawk team still sticking around. Definitely not game over yet, for sure.
Mandy McGurk on the far side wing for Fordham. McGurk uses the screen from Nelson to get to the mid-range. Now Taya Davis has it on this near side wing. Davis picks up her dribble. Pat feeds out for McGurk, who lays it off into the post for Nelson. Nelson, what are they going to say here? They're going to call a foul against UMass Lowell as Nelson made a move to the basket.
Yeah, more impressive play from Nelson on the offensive end. Really good play getting to the rim last possession. Just couldn't finish it on there. And then also drawing a foul there inside. More of what coach is trying to do, getting those high percentage shots around the rim.
Fordham will inbound underneath the basket as Cassidy Mahaney checks in the game for the Rams. Taya Davis will take a seat on the bench. McGurk heaves it off to Mahaney in the far side corner, who sends it back up top for Amy Hayford. 13 to shoot for the Rams. Hayford makes a move to the right side, takes the contact in the lane, but puts up the shot with the right hand and gets it to go.
It's an experienced play, using the body, getting to the rim, and taking a shot that definitely has all account of going in.
Kasha Lima on the near side for UMass Lowell. At the Block F logo, watched closely by Amy Hayford. Lima in for Gitchenko in the mid-range. Gitchenko hands off on the perimeter now for Rodriguez. Leilana Rodriguez straight away to his near side wing into the post for Gitchenko. She couldn't corral the pass. It's a turnover. Amy Hayford streaking back the other way. Finds Flood. Matilda Flood gets the basket and finishes.
Impressive, more impressive transition play from Amy Hayford, really kind of generaling this, you know, battle going through those transition plays.
27-17 Rams under two to go. It's a two-on-one the other way for UMass Lowell. Lima was looking for Gitchenko in the lane, but Lima traveled as she got the pass off. It's another turnover.
You really feel the value of Amy Hayford when they're going downhill after a turnover, after they get the ball back and they're running out quick offensively. She can just get down the floor so fast, and she has so much technique that it really does make the right play every single time down on the offensive end.
So 27-17 Rams with a minute 52 to go in the second quarter. Mandy McGurk across the timeline for Fordham. Rose Nelson at the top of the key, hands off for McGurk, will step into a straightaway three, off back rim, bounces out. An offensive rebound, last touch off Sydney Watkins, and Fordham will keep it on the baseline. A minute 42 to go in this first half.
Watkins, one of the major contributors for this Riverhawk team, has been kind of quiet today and quiet in their last game as well. Look to see her have more of an impact today.
Hayford gets the inbound in for Flood. The handoff back for Hayford, who knocks down the mid-range jumper from the elbow.
More of that impact on the offensive end being felt by Amy Hayford.
Watkins in the backcourt with Flood right there. Watkins accelerates and gets across the timeline. Open for a mid-range jumper. There was Lindsay. That's off back rim. No good. Cassidy Mahaney can secure the board. Fordham again quickly back the other way through Amy Hayford. Mandy McGurk straight away. Out to the far side for Hayford. The minute 10 to go in the second quarter. Hayford, the three, off front rim and out. And last touch again off UMass Lowell on the offensive board. Fordham will keep on the baseline.
And this UMass Lowell team on the offensive end of the ball, Abby Lindsay, seemingly has the greenest of green lights I've ever seen. Seemingly not passing the rock much at all and really taking shots when they're given to her. Seems like her teammates trust her to make those shots a ton.
105 to go in the second quarter, 29-17 Rams. McGurk, the inbound to the far side corner for Donaldson, who buries the three. Taylor Donaldson from downtown. Boy, the Rams missed her the last two games. It's 32-17 Fordham, under a minute to go in this first half.
The more efficiency offensively, the larger this gap, this lead is going to get.
Watkins up top again for Rodriguez. Into the post there for Coombs. Coombs hands off for Rodriguez. This near side wing, Lindsay, will circle to the free throw line and knock down the mid-range jumper.
Shoots another one. She gets open in a spot that she knows she can make it from. Why not shoot it?
35 seconds to go. 32-19 Rams. There's a six-second difference between the shot clock and the game clock. McGurk straight away. Picks up her dribble, hands off for Nelson at the top of the key. Rose Nelson spins in the paint. Nelson, the turnaround jumper, clanks out off back rim. 20 seconds to go in the quarter. Shot clock turned off. UMass Lowell back the other way. That layup no good from Sidney Watkins in transition, but Fordham that call for the foul. Watkins will go to the free throw line.
Yeah, just 15 seconds left in this half. Looking at the scoreboard where it is right now, this Fordham team not really scoring as much as I think they would like. Obviously, UMass Lowell not scoring as much as they would like as well with, you know, sub 20 points right now almost going into halftime. But Fordham really needs to kind of pick up that pace on the offensive end if they want to score more points this afternoon.
So Sidney Watkins, the transfer from Miami of Ohio, is stepped right in to sort of command this UMass Lowell offense as she knocks down her first free throw.
Yeah, that Miami, Ohio experience, an experience that isn't really seen much on this roster for UMass Lowell. Definitely one of the leaders on this squad.
Second free throw clanks out off back rim. Taya Davis grabs the rebound, and with 10 seconds to go, Fordham can hold for the last shot. 8 seconds as Davis enters the front court. 5 to go, still Davis. Davis to the baseline. Davis with the right hand. Her shot no good. Rebound secured by UMass Lowell, and that will end the first half of play. It's Fordham 32, UMass Lowell 20 after a half of play. We'll send it back to our Rose Hill studios for the one-on-one halftime report with Chaz McAdams and Madi Dembele.
The one-on-one halftime report.
Welcome into the one-on-one halftime report. The Fordham Rams up 32-20. On the UMass Lowell Riverhawks. A lot to get into for this halftime report. But first, I'm going to swing it to Madi Dembele for the one-on-one scoreboard.
The one-on-one scoreboard.
Join me once more, Madi Dembele, as I take you around the world of sports. As we stay in the A-10, the Charlotte 49ers handling business as they lead the George Washington Revolutionaries 25-16. As we expand to women's basketball, the Lady Bruins look to remain perfect once more in their second of their back-to-backs against the Purple Eagles, as UCLA takes on the Niagara Purple Eagles. Paradise Jam, number 10 NC State takes on number 3 ranked Colorado. This is basketball, not football, ladies and gentlemen. Crossing over to the men's side, Roll Tide, the Alabama Crimson Tide take on the Oregon Ducks. Again, basketball, not football, later on today at 4 o'clock. The Missouri Tigers doing what they can against the Loyola Maryland Greyhounds. They are nursing a 5-point lead. And then the game's biggest stage, Brooklyn Stand Up. The Miami Heat are in town to take on the Nets tonight at 6 o'clock. The Philadelphia 76ers travel down to Oklahoma City to take on the Thunder at 5. For the one-on-one scoreboard, I am Madi Dembele.
Thank you, Madi. Fantastic as always. Love that great content from you. Bounce back game if I've ever heard one.
Yes.
As the Fordham Rams up 12 on the UMass Lowell Riverhawks. UMass Lowell, not a competitive team in the America East, yet a D1 team nonetheless that still has a lot of talent that this Fordham Rams team, I would say, is beating up on. I think they're pummeling them right now. I think the score does not reflect how good these Fordham Rams are playing.
You know what? The 12-point lead, I would say it's not reflect how well Fordham could play, in fact. I mean, this game has been sloppy. I mean, it's getting better as the game goes along. Naturally, you will catch fire as you get more shots up there. Amy Hayford, specifically, her usage is super high, and we see what she's doing so far. But there's a bright spot, and I think we were talking about this right before. I think it's the offensive rebound, right? Three names to mention. Matilda Flood, I believe she has two offensive
rebounds.
She got two. Two offensive rebounds. Kayla Berry.
She's a dog.
All three of her rebounds are offensive, and as well as, I forget the third name, I think it's Mandy McGurk, who also has one offensive rebound as her own. I think that's going to be the difference in this game, where you see a lot of sloppy play. Extra possessions give you a time to reset, and they give you a chance to go ahead and score baskets on the second try.
Nyborg also getting herself an offensive rebound. You're good. Just want to give everyone their flowers where they're due. Taylor Donaldson's back, obviously. I think that's been huge for the Rams. 3 for 6 from the field, 1 for 2 from three. Amy Hayford taking a lot of shots. I mean, she's been the primary scorer for this team while TD has been out. 4 for 13. I don't know if that reflects. She's been on kind of a tear. The first quarter, it was rough, but she's slowly been building back that confidence and that efficiency.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
But I want to take a second to talk about the turnovers earned for this squad. Over 10 in the first half.
Yeah.
Huge.
Huge.
Huge bounce back from the Manhattan game. And again, I want to address, I was maybe a little harsh on the harsh on those Fordham Rams in that Manhattan game, because that I know they can be so much better than
so
they played
better.
That game, and they're playing like it now.
Mm-hmm.
The Fordham Rams, their style of play changed.
Yeah.
It went from, Coach B talked about good shots versus great shots. And I think those shots weren't there
Yeah.
For in the preceding games this season, they're there now.
They're there now.
Exactly. And you know why they're there?
Why they're there?
Because of effort. I think they're bought in. Kayla Berry, 3 offensive boards. Matilda Flood, 2 to her name, like we were talking about before.
Yeah.
Extra possessions like that, forcing over 10 turnovers on the other team, keeping fouls to a minimum, steals, blocks, Nyborg, 2 swats in the first half. She's a dog in the paint. She's probably going to play around 40 minutes tonight with Amina Lee and Kayla Harris out. How do you as a basketball team create looks in an offense where you haven't seen them before?
I mean,
effort.
Effort is one, and also taking care of the basketball, going through your progressions and your sets. I mean, again, we just saw a bunch of shots that have been missed, but they've been great shots. That's what Coach talked about before the broadcast. Good shots as opposed to great shots. I mean, it's the Fordham way, right? We dig for the loose balls. We grab offensive. We grab every single rebound, not just offensive or defensive, every single rebound. And again, it's the culture. You have a team that's bought in to go after offensive rebound, like it from top to bottom. And again, you got guys that are out, like. This is a system strength in numbers. Like Fordham has it all. I genuinely believe that they could play way better. Again, I don't think the 12-point lead really reflects how well they can play. And again, to give credit to the other side of things, I don't think this as well as they could play. I know that they've been no doubted at the worst team in the league. But I mean, like, they got a few guys like Abby Lindsay right now, 4 of 8. They got guys that have hit all their free throws. I mean, they could turn around too as well.
The Riverhawks?
Yeah.
I don't know. I think the Fordham Rams have them wrapped up, to be fully honest. And I think if they come out, I also think they're not satisfied.
Uh-huh.
And I think they will come out with more aggression than what we've seen, which is already a fantastic amount of aggression.
Yeah.
But I think that is going to do it for us. Besides, for talks about the first half.
Yeah.
But for the second half, what are you looking to see? For the Fordham Rams.
I'm just looking to see a better brand of basketball in terms of taking care of the basketball. It's calm down, slow down. This is your gym. Usually in your gym, you want to play your style of basketball. And again, I'm not too worried about the inefficiency of the players. That will come along as you're coming off of a slew of games where you want to, like, put in the back of your mind. You're going to hit shots as the game goes on. Like 4 for 13 for Amy Hayford, it's not going to be the stat line by the end of the game.
I agree.
So just play your brand of basketball.
And I think... something that's been good, they shot more threes than they did against Manhattan.
Yeah.
Less turnovers. More assists. I think they could still move the ball more, though.
Yeah.
I think, and they're getting the looks that require it. But if you're getting second-chance points and great looks.
Great insurance.
And great looks, you maybe, if you're trying harder than the other team, maybe those assists don't matter as much.
Yeah.
But okay. I think that If the Rams want to compete in the A-10,
yeah.
which as Nick Guzman and them said is right around the corner, they need to be able to play this brand of basketball against a high level. So if they come out more ferocious, and with a lot more angst and
a sense of urgency
and urgency and exigence is a great word. And really, if they want to win, if they can fully buy in. They'll definitely win some basketball games.
Absolutely. I think they'll absolutely buy in. Again, this team, again, I think it's not been noted, their strength in numbers. They got so many guys that could kill you. Again, guys go down, the next one is going to step right up. And I would love to see them pass the ball more because, again, they got so many guys that could kill you on this roster. But, again, Fordham, I'm confident that they play better in the second half. I just want to see a cleaner style of basketball, take care of it, and the good shots will come. And you'll hit those shots. Just keep doing what you're doing, just an improved version of such.
Yeah, definitely. The way that the Rams have changed the play, especially I want to talk about Mandy McGurk.
I think her
usage rate is perfect right now at
22.28.
0-for-2 from 3, which is not ideal for her. She is the 3-point sniper from this team, but she will eventually make those shots. And Taylor Donaldson is also fantastic.
Fantastic, amazing.
Fantastic. Her ability to get through the lane, that tween cross that she likes. She's a cross key scorer.
Very crafty.
And her ability to get to 2 feet and kick out to her shooters, which there's a lot of. I think Matilda Flood will start hitting some threes eventually. Mandy McGurk, as we talked about before. Cassie Mahaney's played this game.
Yeah.
I think Taylor Donaldson's really the key to the offense for these Fordham Rams.
I mean, absolutely, Chaz. And again, Matilda Flood. You go Matilda Flood. Kayla Berry. I really want to emphasize her name because she's someone who really goes unnoted. I know she doesn't appear as much in the box score, but the impact that she brings to offensive rebounding, just cleaning up around the baskets, and she could kill you on some scores that's like, the other team was probably like, ah, I wish I got that score back. So it's just, again, just from 1 to about like 13, so many people on this team can make you regret past decisions if you're playing against this Fordham Rams unit. Again, a cleaner for the nth time, a cleaner brand of basketball. Take care of it, and you're going to get the great shots, and you're going to hit them eventually. Just take the great shots that are coming to you.
But don't you think that sloppy brand of basketball, if they can get a win out in a sloppy game,
it's impressive.
When they're playing at their peak, they'll be even
better? It will be like, wow, look at Fordham. Oh, my God, they're not playing at their best, and still. But you don't want to never not play at your best, right? You always want to keep it clean. You always want to play your style of basketball. You're in the Rose Hill gym, right? You always want to look your best. So that's a hell of a point. Like, oh, my God, look at them. They're not at their best, but still. But ideally, you would like to play at your best.
What do you think has changed? So, like, do you think the mentality has changed from the Manhattan game? I think it's been fantastic to see so far. The way that the offense is flowing in transition has also been very different. That was the only way they could score against the Jaspers not 2 weeks ago. But now, in the half court, they're getting the shots they want, not the shots they need. In the full court.
I mean, Fordham has always been, even to start the season, they've been fantastic in transition. That's one. I've seen some plays, like Amy Hayford, just off the top of my head, like a spin move in transition to get to the back. Beautiful move. But I think they're bought in. Like you said, I think they're bought in. I think the coach has them all in a line. And I think this Fordham, they're playing for each other, with each other. And, they're playing as one cohesive unit. And it's translating over into the half court, not just a strong defensive possession, and then they're going out in transition. But they're actually settling down, and they're understanding each other, and they're trusting each other more.
On the other side of transition, the defense has also been tremendous. I mean, while Fordham has had a couple of bad turnovers, the way they've been able to...
That's the number one thing. Defensive transition defense, because it's so easy to get lost in transition defense, right? You miss a shot, you're upset, and then they're flying down the court, and then maybe it's a 2-on-3, 3-on-2, whatever the situation may be. So keying in on defense and making sure that you're able to get the right defensive stops at the right time, you're golden from there. You could go out on offense and you could score a basket.
Who's a player you wanna key on either side of this matchup for the second half? Who's gonna explode?
I mean, for one, if I'm talking about the Red Hawks, if I'm talking about UMass specifically, I'm looking at Abby Lindsay. She's already 4-for-8, 50% from the field. She missed both of her threes. But I expect her to grow. I expect her to hit some of those. And she already has 8 points, right? So she's gonna be dangerous going down this game. And on Fordham's side of it,
Fordham side of it, I think Miranda Nyborg is going to start beating up on this smaller,
good size
Riverhawks team.
Yeah,
she's only taken two shots on the night. I think that'll change. I think a lot of dumps into her in the low post. She's a beautiful baby hook that can really get the job done wherever you want. And she's been great defensively, as I mentioned. Zero turnovers and three blocks in the first half. But that is going to do it for us for the halftime report. I've been Chaz McAdams with Madi Dembele. You'll see him at the end of the third quarter with the scoreboard, and you'll see me after the game for the postgame report. But let's kick it back to Nick Guzman and Chris Carrino for some second half action in the historic Rose Hill Gym.
Welcome back here inside the Rose Hill Gym. Thank you, Chaz. So Fordham on top of UMass Lowell, 32-20 as we get set to start the second half of action. Nick Guzman here alongside Chris Carrino. And Chris, in that first half, it's 12-point Fordham lead, but Fordham probably not as efficient as they would like to be on the offensive side of the ball despite having that 12-point advantage.
Yeah, only a 32-point total at the end of the half. They're trying to keep that number above 60. Only did that once this year before their Georgian court matchup on Monday where they scored 85. That's a lot more of a number that I think coach would be pleased with for this team. Definitely looking for a bit of an offensive explosion from this Fordham offense in the second half, and I believe that starts and ends with the play of Amy Hayford, already with 9 points at the half.
And we've seen Hayford doing a lot to create stuff on the offensive side of the floor, but it's been such a big key to get Taylor Donaldson back in that lineup. Just another player who can create shots for herself.
Yeah, I feel like we haven't really seen her much. She hasn't taken a lot of shots, really hasn't been dominant on the ball, but that quality, when someone's that good of a player and has that much quality in their game, it shows out no matter what sample size it is, even the small sample size we received today.
Just another option offensively for the Rams. We've got a minute 20 left on the clock before halftime is over and we get ready to start the third quarter. But for Fordham, year one under Coach Bridget Mitchell, and there's been some growing pains. That Miami game was not pretty, and then the Manhattan game here at home, Battle of the Bronx, a game that Fordham hadn't lost since 2010.
and they lose this year to Manhattan College. And now the Rams in a position where they can get some real momentum going heading into conference play. But this game, definitely not over yet, because UMass Lowell have had some weapons offensively, and they've kind of grown into the game as we've gone along.
Yeah, they just haven't gone away. You kind of thought about that first and kind of entrance into the second quarter as really being dominated by Fordham. And then you look at the scoreboard, it's only a 10 or 11 point game. These are the games that are very scary, kind of when you look down the stretch, a team that you feel like you're dominating but is sticking around, you really got to be careful for and not take them for granted at all.
Yeah, for UMass Lowell, it's been Abby Lindsay who's had the green light. 4 of 8 shooting for her with 8 points.
The greenest of green lights.
Greenest of green lights. She's been pulling up from all over the place. She's also been knocking them down for this UMass Lowell team, who's without really their leading scorer in Millie Carrera, who's averaging 11 points per game, the graduate student guard from Lima, Peru. But she's out from this one. But
yeah, similarly to how I feel about the presence of Amy Hayford and how she really can control the game and her talent just seems like shoulders above the people around her, I feel similarly about Sydney Watkins on the other side. Hasn't really done a ton so far in this game, but the redshirt junior, I really expect to have a big second half.
And it would be Carrera who's out in this game, who would normally be doing a lot of the ball handling.
Yeah.
But Watkins has been able to step into that role with Carrera on the sidelines for a second consecutive game.
And also, Goose, Tasha Lima, someone that Coach Bridget Mitchell talked about before the game as maybe someone they would kind of worry about as a focal point for this UMass Lowell offense. Haven't really seen her do too much so far this afternoon. Kind of expecting her to have a big second half as well.
And to start the second half, Fordham will inbound on this near side through Matilda Flood. With 10 minutes on the clock in the third quarter, Flood gets into Davis, and we're underway here in the second half at the Rose Hill Gym. Matilda Flood straight away has it for the Rams. To the near side now for Amy Hayford in the post for Miranda Nyborg. Nyborg, the bounce pass, beautiful to Amy Hayford, who missed the open layup underhand. And back the other way come UMass Lowell.
She was smiling after that one. She knows that's a shot she has to make.
Rodriguez kicks out to the far side for Sydney Watkins. Watkins on the far side wing, up top here for Gitchenko. With Nyborg watching her, to the near side for Lindsay, to the corner there for Rodriguez. Rodriguez in the post looking for Gitchenko, and a whistle and a foul there called against Taylor Donaldson defending against the post.
Yeah, nice to see Taylor Donaldson coming off the injury and still playing with a lot of hustle on that defensive side of the ball, not afraid to put her body, you know, in general in harm's way.
It is Donaldson's third personal foul, but UMass Lowell will inbound underneath. Watkins gets it in there for Rodriguez. Rodriguez circles to the lane, and that is a mid-range jumper. That's perfect there for Maddie Rice. Able to knock it down. It's 32-22 Rams with 40 seconds gone by in this third quarter. Taya Davis across the timeline for the Rams. Matilda Flood swings it out to the far side now for Taylor Donaldson. For Amy Hayford straight away now. Davis on the right side on the perimeter, flipped into Miranda Nyborg over her head in the post. And out of bounds on the baseline, it's a turnover for Fordham.
Yeah, Gitchenko, it's good work defensively inside. Haven't seen a ton of great defense kind of protecting that middle. Seemingly Nyborg getting wherever she wants to go, but really nice to see a defensive stand coming from this Lowell team.
Sydney Watkins on the far side with Fordham providing some pressure. They get it to the front court. Lindsay will pop from the short corner, and that's good again from Abby Lindsay.
The greenest of green lights, it's green for a reason. She's really getting efficient now.
Taya Davis quickly back the other way for the Rams. Flips back up top to the perimeter for Taylor Donaldson. Crossover to the right hand, gets to the basket. The jump pass to Nyborg, she couldn't corral it. And a steal back the other way for Watkins. Watkins into the front court with the lay up top. Now Rodriguez here on the near side wing. Rodriguez to Watkins. Up top there for Gitchenko. Lindsay will pop the three from the far side. That one rims out. Amy Hayford can corral the board and streak back the other way for the Rams on this near side. Up top for Taya Davis. Now Matilda Flood swung out to that far corner for Taylor Donaldson. Donaldson back towards the middle for Davis. Davis gets to the basket, picks up her dribble. This is Nyborg now at the elbow. Flood into the post for Nyborg. Nyborg backing down on Gitchenko. Nyborg spins with the right hand, throws it up. Almost got the shot to go. It rims out. Flood fighting for the board, and she draws the foul.
Matilda Flood all over the place on the floor, just getting into the depths of that defensive boards down there, or the offensive boards, rather. No reason she should be down there working that hard. She is really an impact player on the defensive end for this team.
The inbound is to Flood, who flips it up and in.
She gets rewarded for that out of the inbound from really just inspiring play before that on the possession prior.
34-24 Rams with 7:38 to go. They're trapping Watkins here in the backcourt, but they get it ahead to Lindsay, who'll fire from three off back rim. That bounces out. Taya Davis with the rebound with 7:30 to go in the third quarter. Davis again pushing the tempo for Fordham. Pass out to the far side perimeter for Matilda Flood, straight away for Hayford. And now Donaldson up top. Matilda Flood to the far side wing for Amy Hayford. Hayford circles to the middle, gets the paint. Hayford fights for some space. The lefty layup is good.
Using the body inside and using pivot moves with that great footwork in the paint, really just finding a really high percentage shot right in front of the rim.
Leilana Rodriguez hassled by Taya Davis in the backcourt. They're able to get it ahead to Watkins. And a whistle here with 6:56 to go in the third quarter. And it'll be a timeout on the floor. 36-24 Rams with 6:56 to play in the third quarter. You're listening to Fordham Women's Basketball on WFUV Sports.
Ryan Gregory here, joined with Michael Calamari and Andrew Galata, three of your hosts for Nosebleeds, WFUV's only baseball podcast.
Tune in every week as we recap the latest from the Bronx and Queens, as well as news from around the MLB.
You can listen to Nosebleeds on Apple, Spotify, WFUVsports.org, or wherever you get your podcasts.
Take a trip around the bases all season long with the Nosebleeds podcast on WFUV Sports.
Back here inside the Rose Hill Gym, Fordham on top of UMass Lowell, 36-24 with 6:56 to go in the third quarter. We're in a timeout right now, both teams talking things over. But, Chris, I'd say a positive start to this third quarter for the Rams, able to create some stuff on the offensive side of the floor.
Yeah, I think a positive kind of time for this Ram team, but really I'm more tied in on how UMass could have gotten back into this game at the start of that third quarter. Really had a lot of good looks, just not hitting on them, not efficient enough from the field, but UMass Lowell just a few misses away from really being in this game so far.
Yeah, the margin was 12 heading into the halftime break. It's still 12 here with 6:56 to go.
And that could easily be six, Goose. Just a few more made shots by UMass Lowell, open shots as well. This week could be a two-possession game at best.
It feels like a game where Fordham are getting a lot of open looks, but they're not necessarily falling, and UMass Lowell is just hanging around. You think about Amy Hayford, Fordham's leading scorer. She's only shooting 5 of 15 from the field. Yeah. So a lot of volume, but not necessarily the efficiency.
Yeah, Matilda Flood.
Who's that play down there? Do you think it goes to the level of the intentional foul?
As we're getting a talking to from the referee now, Nicholas Guzman is a bit preoccupied. Guzman, what did she just let us in on?
There was a review to see if there was an intentional foul, or flagrant foul, rather.
Oh, okay.
They went to the review, but no foul, so the ball will be inbound or coming out of this media timeout.
I appreciate getting that early access on the news.
I appreciate it, too. 6:56 to go in this third quarter.
What I was saying was kind of this team, Matilda Flood, I mean, you see her, if you watch any possession of this game, you could see how valuable she is, specifically on the defensive end of the ball, just relentless, never giving up on the play, just really important for this Fordham team. And then even with the kind of offensive woes of Amy Hayford, the less than efficient kind of shooting game she's having tonight, her presence is just felt everywhere else, from playmaking to rebounding to just everywhere on the floor. She can impact the game in so many ways aside from just scoring the ball.
So after the review, no flagrant called. So it'll be Fordham, or UMass Lowell rather, to inbound here in the front court on this near side. And they're able to get it in there for Leilana Rodriguez. Rodriguez out there to the far side for Abby Lindsay now straight away. Lindsay to this near side. Amy Hayford with the steal. She read that perfectly. Hayford all the way. Hayford with the finish.
Contact there on the arm too. Should have been an and one in transition.
Fordham pick right back up with the press in the backcourt. Tasha Lima on the court again for UMass Lowell, able to escape into the front court on this near side. Lima watched closely by Hayford. Now Flood picks her up. Up top it's Gitchenko. Rodriguez. Now getting to the lane. That's a tough shot, but it goes for Maddie Rice. 38-26. Fordham on top with 6:13 to go in the third quarter. Taylor Donaldson in the front court for the Rams. Into the post from Miranda Nyborg on the far side. Now with three. That's from Matilda Flood, and that's perfect. 41-26 Fordham with 6 minutes to play in the third quarter. Rodriguez in the backcourt. Now Lima into the front court. She got bumped by Amy Hayford along the sideline. And Hayford gets called for the foul.
Yeah, Matilda Flood hitting that three on the last offensive possession. You can see her value in all the other ways. But when she's scoring the ball as well, she really just shows how important and valuable she is to this Fordham team. Really just bringing life to them in every single aspect.
An inbound for UMass Lowell in front of their own bench through Watkins. Watkins has it back again here on the near side wing. Watched closely by Amy Hayford. Watkins back towards the middle. Lindsay now straight away. Lindsay circles around to this near side. Still on the perimeter, watched by Davis. In the post for Maddie Rice, they have 8 seconds to shoot it. Lindsay fakes the three, steps into a mid-range jumper. That's an air ball, way too strong. Gitchenko got to the board, but she stepped on the baseline. It's a turnover for UMass Lowell.
Yeah, they're not giving UMass Lowell any sort of good shots to take, any sort of open shots to take. Really just clamping down on all five positions, staying home when they can as well, not getting baited by pump fakes or anything like that. Really playing strong defensive basketball right now.
Okay, Davis will check out Mandy McGurk in the game. McGurk swings to the far side, win for Amy Hayford down the corner. It's Donaldson. She's open for three. Off back rim, no good. Donaldson gets her own rebound, though. And Hayford can settle things down up top. Donaldson to the corner now for Matilda Flood. That one rims out, and a rebound from Lindsay, who can settle things down for UMass Lowell. Sydney Watkins on the far side wing. Gets the screen from Gitchenko. Watkins into the post for Gitchenko. Working against Donaldson, Hayford comes to help. Pick out for Lindsay to this near side corner now for Rodriguez. 10 seconds on the shot clock. Rodriguez works back towards the middle. Now against Nyborg. The jumper from mid-range, off back rim and out. Flood fighting for the board. Last touch there off Maddie Rice. Fordham will take possession.
Maddie Rice, she's the daughter of former Dallas Cowboy Antonio Rice. Made that shot earlier a couple possessions ago. But yeah, inspired play. Nice to see UMass Lowell kind of getting other people into the mix. Obviously, we've seen, you know, the likes of people like Abby Lindsay taking a lot of shots, or people like Sydney Watkins with a lot of ball time. But it's nice to see other people getting involved as well.
So with 4:43 to go in the third quarter, we'll head into a media timeout. It's Fordham 41, UMass Lowell 26. You're listening to Fordham Women's Basketball on WFUV Sports.
What's going on, guys? I'm Jack Warner, one of your New York Rangers beat reporters for the 2023-2024 NHL season. I'll have you covered all season long as New York looks to bring a Stanley Cup back to the Big Apple in Peter Laviolette's first season as head coach. Follow me on Twitter at Jack_Warner23 for live game updates, post-game media availability, and all things Blue Shirts.
Inside the Rose Hill Gym, it's Fordham 41, UMass Lowell 26 with 4:43 to go in the third quarter. We're in a media timeout right now. Nick Guzman here alongside Chris Carrino. And Chris, we keep saying UMass Lowell are hanging around, but Fordham are still causing their chaos on the defensive end by pressing and having these double teams, but it seems like UMass Lowell's been able to work around that a little bit better as we've moved on.
Yeah, it seems like Fordham's kind of starting to pull away now. 15 is the largest lead it's been for a long time in this game so far, but it's really just the efficiency on the offensive end, real clamping defense on the defensive end, and really not letting this UMass Lowell team get any sort of high percentage looks from the field, really forcing the Riverhawks to take a lot of bad shots in the second half. I think that's kind of been what has been the biggest benefit for this Fordham team so far. And once you stop them on the defensive end of the ball, it really just kind of a race with yourself on the offensive side. Not a ton to worry about, not a shootout or anything of that nature.
We keep seeing the Rams trying to push the tempo after they get a steal, after they get a rebound, no matter what the situation is. It's Taya Davis, Amy Hayford, using the speed they have. And it is a real advantage because they they're able to blow by these UMass Lowell defenders in transition.
Yeah, players like Taylor Donaldson, players like Amy Hayford, they're players with such skill and speed, especially in transition when they're moving from side to side, from the backcourt to frontcourt, that you have to use them. It's almost too valuable not to use. Obviously, Taya Davis, also another player that can do that, but really, the stars of the show, Taylor Donaldson and Amy Hayford, have just such a control over the ball, such a control over the game when they're playing in these fast-paced kind of sectors of the game, such as the transition play.
Hayford is Fordham's leading scorer on the day with 13 points on 6 of 16 shooting. Donaldson has 7 so far in her return to action.
Yeah.
As we're ready to get out of this media timeout, the Rams will inbound underneath their own basket in the backcourt through Matilda Flood. 5 for Fordham now is Matilda Flood, Taya Davis, Mandy McGurk, Rose Nelson, and Taylor Donaldson. We're back underway here. It's Davis in the backcourt, who will carry ahead for Fordham across the timeline. To Mandy McGurk on this near side wing. McGurk down low for Matilda Flood. Flood, physical play. Defender fell down. Flood regathered and flipped it to Nelson, who couldn't corral it. That'll be a turnover against the Rams.
Yeah, haven't seen many sloppy turnovers like that in the half-court offense from this Fordham Ram team. Bit of an anomaly so far this afternoon.
But after the referees conversed, they switched the call. The pass was deflected, and Fordham will inbound underneath in the frontcourt.
Just how it's going this afternoon. Even when it's a turnover, it's not.
Taya Davis gets into Matilda Flood on that far side short corner. Now Mandy McGurk up top. Hands off for Taya Davis. Davis the crossover, gets to the rack. Davis, the righty layup, off backboard, didn't hit the rim. And a rebound there from Leilana Rodriguez, who can break back the other way for UMass Lowell. Hands off here for Abby Lindsay up top. Lindsay the bounce pass there for Rice. Lindsay again. Lindsay circles around. Got inside. Lost possession going up for the basket. And it's a turnover.
More good defense. I mean, that's really where they're prioritizing inside the paint there, those high percentage kind of parts of the court that are really giving easy looks. They close down on those, send double teams, things of that nature. It makes it hard for players like Abby Lindsay to get a bucket close to the rim.
Under 4 to go in the third quarter, 41-26 Rams. Mandy McGurk is open from the mid-range, escapes to the baseline underneath the basket, feeds off for Nelson. Taylor Donaldson wide open for 3, and she buries it.
One of those players, when she's wide open like that from behind the arc, it's going in.
44-26 Rams. This is Watkins escaping into the front court for UMass Lowell, and they're going to call a timeout here with 3:35 to go in the third quarter. The Riverhawks will talk things over. Denise King wants to communicate some things to her group, but Chris, we'll keep it here for this timeout. But 44-26 Rams starting to finally pull away here in the third.
Yeah, Denise King, her team not happy about it, calling a quick timeout after the media timeout we just went through. I think she's kind of a bit frustrated with not taking advantage of those Fordham mistakes that they're making on the offensive and defensive end, but really just the clamping down on the defensive end for this Fordham Ram team, not making anything easy whatsoever for this UMass Lowell team on the offensive side of the ball. I think that's really what's got Coach King frustrated so far.
Coach King is a 16-43 overall record as head coach of the UMass Lowell Riverhawks, 12-21 conference record. But despite what you would think is a poor record, UMass Lowell qualified for the America East tourney in both their first two seasons under Coach King, as we're underway after the quick 30-second timeout. Rice hands off for Lindsay straight away. Lindsay circling around now to this near side wing. Lindsay still with it on the perimeter. Watched closely by Flood. Pass straight away there for Sydney Watkins. Watkins out to the far side for Rodriguez. She'll try the three. No good. That clanks out. And a rebound from Flood, who gets it to Mandy McGurk, who can escape ahead for Fordham. McGurk for Flood. Up top on the perimeter to this near side wing for Taylor Donaldson. Donaldson crosses over to the baseline. Donaldson puts it up with the left hand. That's a foul. And Taylor Donaldson will go to the free throw line.
That ambitious style of offense coming from Donaldson there is a really great sign. Even if it's not going in, the fact that she's being productive, getting to the free throw line, and also just not afraid of, you know, putting it on the floor, really getting physical inside. Good signs for this Fordham Ram team.
In her return to the lineup, 10 points so far for Donaldson, 3 rebounds and 2 assists. These are her first free throws of the day, and the first one swishes home.
Really showing how well, how good she is, and really how much of an impact player she is in this second half so far.
Second free throw is also perfect from Donaldson. 46-26 Rams with 3 minutes to play in the third quarter. They're up by 20. Double team in the backcourt from Flood and Davis. Pass ahead for Rice, who can escape into the front court. Now the Riverhawks have numbers the other way. This is Rice, who can flip up the open leg with the right hand and in. 46-28 Fordham. Taya Davis the other way for the Rams. Will hold and pause up top. Flood to this near side wing for Mandy McGurk. McGurk up top for Flood again. Flood, blow by, the finish with the right hand and the foul.
It's a pretty move using her frame to absorb that kind of contact driving inside, similarly to what we've been talking about all afternoon for this Fordham offense, and then making the shot on top of it. The cherry on top to a great play and great afternoon for Matilda Flood.
The speed there from Flood to blow by her defender and get the space for the scoop layup with the right hand. She's got 9 points. Make it 10 as she completes the three-point play.
She's all over the stat sheet. 10 points, 5 rebounds, 2 assists. She's really doing it in every single way this afternoon.
The press doesn't stop from the Rams. Lindsay to the far side for Watkins, who can cross the timeline. But she's double-teamed in front of the sideline with Flood and Taya Davis, and Fordham will get whistled for the foul.
Yeah, she tried to hit it off the leg of Taya Davis there, trying to get it to go out of bounds off of Fordham, but just got kind of caught up there. That trap is very effective. Really had this overall UMass Lowell team really frustrated, including Sydney Watkins.
Watkins will inbound in front of her own bench. She gets it in there for Rodriguez up top with Mandy McGurk watching her. Rodriguez gets the screen from Rice. Pass in there for Rain Durant back on the court. The beautiful feed inside for Lindsay. Her layup won't go. Rose Nelson fighting for the rebound. She comes down with it and a foul against UMass Lowell.
Yeah, more great play here from Fordham. Really not giving them any extra chances than they already have. This UMass Lowell team really limiting mistakes and really just trying to win their best game possible. Really inspiring stuff.
2:09 to go in the third quarter, 49-28 Rams. Taya Davis with the ball in the front court for Fordham. On the near side for Mandy McGurk. McGurk uses the screen from Nelson to get towards the middle. She tried to feed Nelson on the pick and roll. It's turned over. Back the other way comes Watkins for UMass Lowell. Watkins breaks through and the beautiful layup with the left hand goes. 49-30 Fordham. Davis to McGurk in transition. McGurk gets inside. McGurk with the tough layup. Back and forth action here at the Rose Hill Gym. 51-30 Fordham.
Surprised I'm not in the field house. Feels like a track meet right now.
Donaldson got a tip on that pass in the backcourt. Able to recover was Watkins, and up ahead here for Durant. Durant back for Watkins up top, and UMass Lowell will settle things down with a minute 25 to go in the third quarter. Watkins the crossover to her left hand on the near side. Now circling back toward the middle. Up top for Rice, the handoff for Rodriguez. Rodriguez on the far side wing. Towards the middle. Lindsay, the ambitious three is blocked away by McGurk as the shot clock expires.
Again, great play there on the defensive end from this Fordham team. As I kind of mentioned earlier, those runners in the Lombardi Fieldhouse ain't got nothing on the women out here. They are really just going back and forth, running from defense to offense, and it really takes a high level of conditioning to get to this point.
I think intensity is the word to use.
Yeah.
Just excellent intensity, both offense and defense for this Fordham team. With a minute to play in this third quarter, they lead 51-30. Hayford to Taya Davis up top in the front court for the Rams. Davis gets inside the crossover, the pull-up jumper from the mid-range. Planks off back rim and a foul called underneath.
Miranda Nyborg, she's been battling down low all game. You'll get rewarded with fouls like that if you just continue to battle throughout the game.
Fordham now into the bonus, so Miranda Nyborg will shoot free throws with 50.8 to go in this third quarter. I think Nyborg's been tasked with playing a lot of minutes with Lee and Harris both out. She's done her job well.
Absolutely.
4 points on the day as she misses the first free throw off front rim. Nyborg just one of three returning players from this Fordham team. Or four, rather. Nyborg, Kayla Berry, Matilda Flood, and Rose Nelson coming back this season.
Three for four for the free throw line for Nyborg. Like to see her knocking those down.
The second free throw goes 52-30 Fordham in the front court for UMass Lowell. Into the corner for Lindsay. Nyborg with the steal, but UMass able to get it right back. And back up top for Sydney Watkins. 30 seconds to go in the quarter, 10 to go on the shot clock. Watkins into the post there for Durant. Durant against Hayford, 5 seconds to shoot. Pass deflected by Nyborg. And out of bounds, last touch off Davis with just 2 seconds to shoot for UMass Lowell.
Yeah, they're going to have to get a shot out quick. Fordham probably with one more possession for the quarter. They want to try and get a defensive stop here, though. Don't want to let anything happen with 2 seconds.
Watkins inbound underneath, looking for Lindsay. They get it to Lindsay on the far side. Lindsay, the tough mid-range jumper, doesn't hit the rim.
Wasn't hard to guess with 2 seconds left who's getting the ball for this UMass Lowell team. Seems like Abby Lindsay has been the shot taker whenever they've needed one so far this afternoon.
Shot clock violation, so Taya Davis will carry the ball up with the shot clock off. 15 seconds to go in the third quarter. Fordham on top, 52-30. They'll hold here for the last shot of the quarter. Davis the Block F logo, 8 seconds to go. Davis, now 5 to go, needs to start something on offense. Davis getting to the basket with 2. Davis, the tough layup. She's fouled, and she'll go to the free throw line with 1.6 to go.
Yeah, as I said, Taya Davis getting a bit overshadowed by her counterparts, Taylor Donaldson and Amy Hayford, but still with a ton of talent, Davis really able to just get to the rim and get through those crevices and also draw fouls around the rim as well. Either way, making the shot or going to the line, efficient play offensively from her.
2 points, 3 rebounds, 2 assists. Make that 3 points now for Davis on the day. 53-30 Rams. 1.6 to go in the quarter. Davis will shoot another. Second one rims out. Rebound UMass Lowell. And that will do it for the third quarter. Fordham pulling away in this third period. It's 53-30. Rams on top of UMass Lowell. We'll send it back to our Rose Hill studios for the one-on-one scoreboard with Madi Dembele.
The one-on-one scoreboard.
Ladies and gentlemen, stick around with me, Madi Dembele, as I take you around the world of sports. Staying in the A-10, the Charlotte 49ers handling business as they lead the George Washington Revolutionaries 43-33. Expanding to the scope of women's basketball as a whole, the Lady Bruins standing on business in their second of their back-to-back against the Purple Eagles as UCLA is dog-walking Niagara 47-13. The Paradise Jam is here, number 10 NC State taking control of the number 3 ranked Colorado 41-26. Everyone's favorite LSU Lady Tigers takes on the Cavaliers in a Cayman Islands Classic today at 5 o'clock. Crossing over to the men's side of things, George Mason and East Carolina, interesting game there as the Patriots lead the Pirates 13-6. The Missouri Tigers fend off the Loyola Maryland Greyhounds. They take the day 78-70. Roll Tide, the Alabama Crimson Tide take on the Oregon Ducks. Again, basketball, not football, later on today at 4. The game's biggest stage as Brooklyn stand up. The Miami Heat are in town to take on the Nets tonight at 6 o'clock p.m. And the Philadelphia 76ers travel down to Oklahoma City to take on the Thunder today at 5. For the one-on-one scoreboard, I am Madi Dembele.
After three quarters of play here in the Rose Hill Gym, Fordham with a 53-30 lead over UMass Lowell. Nick Guzman here alongside Chris Carrino. And Chris, we were kind of waiting for Fordham to pull away in this game, and it happened in this third quarter. They're 7 of 13 shooting overall, 2 of 4 from 3, 5 of 7 free throws, and really outscoring UMass 21-10 in that third period.
Yeah, it seems like they finally kind of pulled away now. Good vibes in the historic Rose Hill Gym. People dancing on the fan cam on the Jumbotron. Just seems like good vibes all around from the Fordham side of things. From the UMass Lowell side of things, it's really gotten stagnant on the offensive side of the ball. You see Coach King getting a little downtrodden on the sideline when she sees her team again force up another inerrant three that is really contested. It's happened almost 3 or 4 times in that third quarter. So really just downtrodden kind of vibes on the side of the Riverhawk, and high vibes, really exciting times for this Rams team. They're enjoying all the success they've had, not only tonight, but this entire week.
Yeah, UMass Lowell 0 for 4 from 3 in that third quarter. A lot of wild shots, a lot of possessions where the shot clock was going down to the wire, and they had to force up a tough shot.
And that's a testament to this Fordham defense. This Fordham defense has locked up any sort of easy or just even efficient ways of scoring for this UMass Lowell team, really making them try to get it in every single hard way they possibly can.
So 10 minutes on the clock here in the fourth quarter, 53-30 Rams. UMass Lowell will inbound to get us started on the near side through Sydney Watkins. And Watkins gets it in there for Gabby Ross, who will cross the Block F logo into the front court. Ross, the handoff there for Lindsay on the perimeter. Lindsay circles around, gets through the two-man pressure there from Fordham. Now up top, it's Durant. Durant hands off on the far side for Watkins. Watkins, pass deflected by Hayford. It's a double team with her and Nyborg. And Watkins stepped on the sideline. Another turnover.
Another turnover. Fordham taking advantage of all these mistakes that this UMass Lowell team is making on the offensive end, and Fordham not making as many on the offensive end themselves, really kind of being the difference in this game so far.
Rose Nelson inbounds to Taya Davis in the backcourt for Fordham. 20 seconds gone by in this fourth quarter. Davis to the far side wing for Amy Hayford. Hayford in the middle for Rose Nelson. Nelson gets the lane. Nelson, the fall-away jumper. She gets the roll.
Pretty stuff. She's had a bunch of pretty moves in this game so far and didn't get the shots to go. She gets that one to go. Pretty little turnaround move in the middle of the paint.
Gabby Ross the other way for UMass Lowell. It's 55-30 Fordham now. 9:15 to go in the fourth quarter. Ross working on the far side ring. Gets inside. Pass to Rice off her hands. Durant able to gather. Amy Hayford busted up that handoff, and it's a jump ball.
Another more tenacious, aggressive defense, kind of what you brought up earlier, Goose. It's really great to see from this Fordham team. It would be nice to see them kind of keep this up in more higher levels of competition and maybe even into conference play. We're always talking about what we want to bring into conference play. That kind of tenaciousness is something you want to see in Atlantic 10 basketball.
Mandy McGurk will carry the ball ahead for the Rams. Amy Hayford on the far side. Hayford gets the screen from Nelson, works right towards the middle. Pass inside, looking for Nelson, deflected, and a turnover. Lindsay back the other way for UMass Lowell. Lindsay working against McGurk, gets to the baseline, absorbs the contact, and finishes strongly. 55-32 Rams now. McGurk in the backcourt with 8:40 to go in the fourth quarter. McGurk to this near side win for Taylor Donaldson. Pass inside for Nelson. She's got positioning. Nelson flips it up and in and one.
Another play and one. She's been absorbing the contact and finishing all game, finally getting rewarded for it with some points right now.
Rose Nelson will go to the free throw line for one more. It's 57-32 Rams. Nelson with 4 points on it. It's a player that you would just like to see shoot the ball more for this Fordham team. Had a ton of field goal attempts despite playing a lot of minutes so far this season.
Yeah, she's extremely shifty, especially when you get down toward the paint area. She really uses that great footwork to her advantage.
You can't finish the three-point play. It's off back rim. UMass Lowell the rebound, and they'll advance it to the front court through Sydney Watkins, now circling out to the far side wing. Watkins. Pass inside there from Worley, deflected away by Hayford.
More of that great defense. Fordham not giving an inch defensively all afternoon.
Sydney Coombs back in the game, number 20 for UMass Lowell. And Sydney Watkins will inbound underneath the basket. Watkins looking for an option, gets it in, a pass deflected again, and last touch there off Gabby Ross, another turnover.
Mandy McGurk always seems to be around these turnovers for UMass Lowell, along with Matilda Flood. Matilda Flood hasn't gotten as many minutes here in the second half, but really Mandy McGurk has just been dominating defensively, really just been a force on that side of the ball.
Yeah, already with 2 5-second calls for UMass Lowell. They're almost close to a third one there, but the Rams force a turnover anyway. It's Amy Hayford on the near side. She'll step back from three. Off front rim, no good. And a rebound there from Leilana Rodriguez. Rodriguez working back the other way against Hayford on this near side. Rodriguez in the corner for Lindsay. Fakes the jumper, gets to the baseline with the left hand, and layup's good.
Yeah, more good play from Abby Lindsay, one of the only real productive people on the offensive end for this Riverhawk team.
57-34 Fordham with 7:40 to play in the fourth quarter. McGurk for Rose Nelson. For Miranda Nyborg at the top of the key, hands off for McGurk. Pull-up jumper from the elbow, and that's perfect.
She's doing it on both ends of the floor. Similar kind of vision and personality on both sides, not giving an inch, really taking everything that she's been given. She's doing it on both sides right now.
Up ahead for UMass Lowell, it's Rodriguez. Into the post now for Coombs. Coombs kicks it out there for Worley, and Worley traveled.
Yeah, that's a testament to great defense that's being played by Rose Nelson as well. That presence and that pressure right in front of her in the three-point stance really can cause travels like that, especially on a pump fake.
So it's 59-34 Rams with 7:10 to go in the fourth quarter. McGurk bounce pass to Amy Hayford on this near side wing. Hayford to the middle for Nyborg, who hands back off for Hayford. To the far corner, McGurk fakes the three, gets inside, now retreats back to the perimeter through Hayford. Hayford to McGurk, into the post for Nyborg. Nyborg, the bounce pass for McGurk. Beautiful passing from the Ram, and McGurk flips it up and in.
A fantastic pass. Able to have Nyborg, who's such a big presence inside, also be able to make passes like that, very valuable for this Fordham team.
On the far side wing for UMass Lowell, Leilana Rodriguez. Now Worley on the near side. Back to the far side wing for Watkins. Looking for Coombs in the post. The cross-court pass to Lindsay, who fakes the three, gets to the baseline again. Off-balance shot, no good. Hayford rips the rebound away. It'll call it a jump ball.
Yeah, just more aggressive play on this defensive side of the ball. No matter what the scoreboard says, I mean, this Fordham lead's almost grown out to 30 now with 6 minutes left to go. Still that level of tenaciousness not going away on the defensive side of the ball for the Rams.
Substitutions here for the Rams. Kayla Berry will check into the game, as will Matilda Flood, as Rose Nelson and Amy Hayford will check out. UMass Lowell basketball underneath the basket. They get it in there for Rodriguez. Rodriguez gets inside to flip for Coombs. Mid-range jumper too strong. But an offensive rebound there from UMass Lowell, and it's flipped back up and in by Worley.
It's bound to happen on the defensive end to kind of get got, almost, for lack of a better term. But, yeah, this Fordham team just needs to continue that mindset they have on the defensive side of the ball. Don't get distrayed from and-ones or fouls like that. Really continue playing your brand of defensive basketball.
Worley will try to finish the three-point play from the free-throw line. 61-36 Rams with 6:18 to play in the fourth quarter. Worley's free throw is good. 61-37 now. McGurk in the backcourt can carry ahead across the timeline. McGurk breaks towards this near side wing, and she's fouled by Tasha Lima.
Mandy McGurk's a really great player. I mean, I don't want to talk generally in that sense, but the way she has just almost the biggest impact on the entire roster off the bench, and she seemingly is around every single positive play for this team, she really is showing her excellence today.
McGurk gets it for Donaldson. Back to McGurk up top. And that's going to be an offensive foul against Mandy McGurk.
Interesting. A little bit too much tenaciousness, Goose.
She pushed off a little bit there, so a turnover. And UMass Lowell inbound right in front of us. Through Worley. Into Rodriguez across the timeline. Circles to that far side in front of the UMass Lowell bench. Gets a screen from Coombs. Watkins up top. Coombs calling for it in the post against McGurk. They switch to get Nyborg on her. Worley to Coombs from the short corner. The jumper off front rim, no good. Brandon Nyborg grabs the board. She collided with Kayla Berry, who's a little bit shaken up in the backcourt. Taylor Donaldson back the other way for the Rams in transition as Berry can join the play. The handoff for Donaldson on the far side. Now McGurk up top. Swung back to the far side for Donaldson. Donaldson, the screen from Nyborg. Donaldson thought about the shot from mid-range, pushed out to McGurk. McGurk's the step back. That's perfect from Mandy McGurk. Knocks down the mid-range jumper. 63-37 Rams.
Mid-range shooting, a lost element in the modern-day basketball game, but so valuable. Needs to be used more.
Sydney Watkins the other way with 5:08 to go in this fourth quarter. Coombs thought about a three-pointer, now dishes off to the far side. Rodriguez gets to the basket and finishes well with that right hand.
Yeah, pretty move from Rodriguez from the Massachusetts native.
McGurk in the backcourt with under 5 to play in this fourth quarter. 63-39 Fordham. McGurk the bounce pass up ahead to Donaldson, who finds Miranda Nyborg in the middle. Nyborg at the top of the key, makes her move to the basket, flipped that one up with her right hand. Off the bottom of the rim, but a foul called, and Nyborg will go to the free throw line.
Nyborg, as we've talked about all afternoon, stepping up with injuries in front of her, seemingly doing everything out there, including that absolutely fantastic bounce pass she made earlier. She is really showing her value here today this afternoon.
And with 4:45 to go in the fourth quarter, we've reached our media timeout. It's Fordham 63, UMass Lowell 39. You're listening to Fordham Women's Basketball on WFUV Sports.
What's going on, guys? Bridge Gotham here, your New York Giants beat reporter for WFUV Sports. Be on the lookout for weekly reports and game recaps on WFUV's YouTube channel. We'll be covering the action all season long. Feel free to follow me on Twitter at BGBridge for updates throughout the games. For all things Big Blue, stay tuned all season long.
Welcome back inside the Rose Hill Gym. Fordham on top of UMass Lowell, 63-39, with 4:45 to play in this fourth quarter. Nick Guzman here alongside Chris Carrino. The Rams really have pulled away throughout the second half. It was closer than I think we thought the game would be coming in, with UMass Lowell being 0-5 on the season and really struggling at times. But they're a team that, coming into this game, Chris, kept games close against BU and Lemoyne. We think it's a team that has more talent than an 0-5 team, but Fordham really able to establish their dominance here in the second half.
Yeah, absolutely. Fordham really showing the talent that they have around. They've played up to their potential through most of the season. Miami, a team with just a lot more talent than they do. Manhattan game that, truthfully, they probably should have won with the talent they had out there. But today, really living up to all the talent they have on their roster. Women like Amy Hayford and Taylor Donaldson, kind of the usual suspects for any Fordham women's basketball fans. But people like Matilda Flood, Mandy McGurk, really, to me, making the difference today, not only on the offensive end of the ball, which they're scoring at will, but also on the defensive end of the ball, really pioneering and kind of leading that tough, rugged, as I've been saying all afternoon, tenacious defense for this Fordham Ram team.
And Fordham has been spreading the ball around on the offensive side of the floor. Last game against Georgian Court, six different Rams were in double figures. Today that number is four. It's Matilda Flood with 10, Taylor Johnson with 12, Amy Haver with 13, and then Mandy McGurk leading the way with 14 points for this Fordham team.
Yeah, Mandy McGurk, I feel, as I said, kind of going into the break earlier, every time there's something good happening, offensive or defensive, for this Fordham team, I feel like a number 11 in white or number 1 in white, either Mandy McGurk or Matilda Flood, is in the middle of it and causing some sort of havoc.
And it's the efficiency, too, for McGurk, because Donaldson and Haver are players are going to take a lot of shots. McGurk's done this on 7 of 10 shooting.
Yeah.
It's even more impressive.
Yeah, efficiency matched with just knowing where to pick her spots, always making the right play, never forcing anything. That's where that efficiency on the offensive end comes from.
So 4:45 to go in the fourth quarter as we come out of this media timeout. It's Fordham 63, UMass Lowell 39. And it will be UMass Lowell early free throws, rather, for Miranda Nyborg as she was fouled right before the media timeout. Two shots for Nyborg. Played the bulk of the minutes at that number five position for the Rams.
Not a ton of rotation in this Fordham lineup. A lot of the same faces playing a lot of minutes this afternoon.
Nyborg's first free throw swishes home.
Also talked about that point total for Fordham around 60, where they wanted it a little bit higher. They're going to separate themselves now with 65 points with that made free throw from Nyborg. Now they can kind of get into the echelon of 70 or even 80 points today.
Second free throw goes as well. 65-39 Rams with 4:37 to go in the fourth quarter. This is Lindsay straight away against Mandy McGurk. Crossover to the right hand, now to the far side. That's Leilana Rodriguez working against Taylor Donaldson. Gets the screen from Combs to Lindsay. She's got some space for three, and that's perfect from Lindsay. 65-42 with 4:20 to go in the fourth quarter. And now a full court press on from UMass Lowell. They got to that one. The last touch off of Sydney Watkins, and Fordham will inbound again in the backcourt.
Yeah, for this UMass Lowell team, a little more attention being paid defensively now, really going on a hard press, trying to make sure Fordham can't get it over half court, trying to come back with some sort of rally here with just 4 minutes left.
Kayla Berry, Cassidy Mahaney in the game, Mandy McGurk, Taylor Donaldson check out as Taya Davis crosses the timeline. Now Matilda Flood on the near side wing, pushes it into the middle for Miranda Nyborg. Flood fakes the three, gets inside, Flood, she walked. Trying to create some space, getting in the lane. It's a travel, just an extra step.
That's what happened. She has such great footwork getting to the rim, as we've seen all afternoon today, Flood is. But, you know, you're going to get caught like that sometimes. Take one too many steps going to the rim.
3:55 to go in the fourth quarter. Leilana Rodriguez up ahead for UMass Lowell. Bounce pass to the far side wing for Abby Lindsay towards the middle. It's now Worley working against Nelson. Lindsay back to the middle, gets to the lane, flips up the layup with the right hand. That's good. Abby Lindsay's been a bright spot for UMass Lowell.
Yeah, that was absolutely pretty. We haven't seen finishing that acrobatic all afternoon.
And then in the backcourt, Taya Davis is called for a travel, so that's a turnover for the Rams. A little bit sloppy here this last minute or so.
Yeah, Fordham can't let their bridges burn down just quite yet. They still got a little more time left in this game.
3:38 to go. Sydney Watkins off the inbounds, deflected by Davis, and it's a steal by Nelson. Davis back the other way for Flood on the far side. Flood is in the near corner for Cassidy Mahaney. Swings it back to the middle for Davis, all the way to the far side for Flood, who steps into a three and knocks it down.
A lot going on there in that possession. At the end of the day, you're going to find someone like Matilda Flood in the corner, open for a three. Again, Fordham just making the right plays on the offensive side of the ball.
68-44 Rams with 3:10 to go in the fourth quarter. This is Coombs working in the post. Her hook shot against Nyborg is no good. Davis the rebound and back the other way for Fordham. Davis will slow things down, under 3 minutes to play in the fourth quarter. Davis hands off for Flood. 15 to shoot for the Rams. Nyborg at the free throw line will turn around and take the mid-range jumper and knock it down.
Second time she's taken that shot from that spot on the court, just above the bubble, just below the perimeter. Hasn't even hit the rim once, just been straight cash.
70-44 Rams. Leilana Rodriguez, we play out the rest of this 2:30. Coombs straight away to the far side for Watkins against Nyborg to Coombs in the post against Flood. Coombs spins the right-handed shot, won't go, but she'll go to the free throw line, the foul against Flood.
Yeah, Matilda Flood just all over her there. Didn't really give much room for Sydney Coombs to make that shot. Definitely deserved a foul there. She goes to the bench now.
So with 2:23 to go, Matilda Flood will check out.
Two shots here for the Rams with Kayla Berry back in the game. Or two shots here for UMass Lowell, rather, through Combs. First one rims out from Coombs, but for UMass Lowell, they're going to fall to 0-6 on the season, which is not ideal. If there's a bright spot, last season they were 0-7 and managed to bounce back and make the America East tournament.
Yeah, as you brought up earlier in the broadcast, they won their last three conference games to storm into the quarterfinals of that America East tournament. Maybe they could fix up some sort of comeback this season as well. It's still early, only six games in. Wouldn't really press the panic button yet. Got to get into conference play first.
So it's 70-44 Rams with 2 minutes to go. Nyborg out to this near side wing for Rose Nelson. Goes to the basket. Nyborg down the mid-range. Up top straightaway for Cassidy Mahaney. Mahaney, the step-back jumper off side rim. Bounces out, no good. Last touch there off Rose Nelson. UMass Lowell basketball with 2 minutes to play.
Yeah, we're going
to
get a big substitution here now from UMass Lowell. Oh, I thought so. All the women stood, and I got a little confused. Nonetheless, this Fordham team continuing to have a level of consistency, not straying away from it, but really feeding into it, continuing to play good basketball.
Abby Lindsay straight away into the post for Gitchenko just on the court. Gitchenko against Davis, uses her size, and the right-handed shot goes. 70-46 with a minute 40 to play in the fourth quarter.
Yeah, Davis has been getting mismatches all day defensively, finally taking advantage of one as she makes a layup on the other end.
Coast to coast, Taya Davis flips it up and in. 72-46 Rams. Lindsay the other way. The reverse layup. Nyborg says no. Nyborg with the rejection.
Definition of a rejection.
Taya Davis, the bounce pass to Nyborg. The Rams showing off now as Miranda Nyborg finishes the easy layup.
That's pretty stuff. It's what I've been talking about all afternoon, letting great defense translate into good offense. The 2-on-3 there, easy score for the Rams.
74-46 Fordham with a minute 05 to go in the fourth quarter. Into the post there for Gitchenko. Mahaney and Nelson were there. And a whistle and a foul called against Cassidy Mahaney. But for these Rams, it's going to be two wins in a row after those two losses to Manhattan and Miami. You're going to be 4-2 on the season.
Yeah.
And I think a lot to be positive about in terms of this performance.
Yeah, those Miami and Manhattan games were demoralizing for sure. Nice to see them get two victories back in the win column.
Another sloppy inbound underneath for UMass Lowell. Lindsay gets to it, though. Inside for Worley, working against Berry. She lost her balance. And that jumper is no good there from Watkins, still fighting for it. Outside for Lindsay, she'll try the corner shot. That's perfect. It's a two-pointer.
She's going to keep shooting them, Goose. She's definitely not going to stop.
Abby Lindsay, a volume shooter for this UMass Lowell team. 74-49 with 40 seconds to go in the fourth quarter. Taya Davis into the front court. Lindsay, 9 of 21 shooting on the day. Davis to Cassidy Mahaney with 30 seconds to go. The Rams will slow things down. The screen from Nyborg out to the far side for Nelson and Taya Davis. 9 seconds to shoot for Fordham. Davis gets inside, ran into a wall. Nyborg from mid-range. Money from Miranda Nyborg. She's been cashed from the mid-range all day long.
Yeah, I thought Taya Davis got fouled going into the paint there. Nice pass back outside, making the right play, finding an open Nyborg.
10 seconds to go. Dribbling around is Watkins in the front court. We'll see if UMass Lowell go for another shot. This is Lindsay with 5 seconds. Lindsay gets to the lane, a wild layup. And that will do it here at the Rose Hill Gym. Final score, Fordham 76. UMass Lowell 49, a comprehensive victory for the Rams, Chris.
Yeah, a lot of the things that this Fordham team would try to improve on that two-game skid with Manhattan and Miami, they did in Georgian court, and they continue. They accentuated them today. The fast-paced play, both offensively and defensively, matched with an aggression and tenacity on the defensive end, really getting after it, really taking advantage of River Hawk mistakes, and then using that to translate into good offense on the other side. Not as efficient, maybe, as Coach would maybe want them to be, but that efficiency will come as the season goes along. A lot of positive stuff for the Fordham Rams today.
And when we talked with Coach B before the game, she said 16 turnovers or less would be considered a win. Fordham had 13 turnovers today, so they hit that target.
And a clean game as well. Didn't feel like they had many turnovers. Really seemed like they were making the most of all their opportunities and not giving any opportunities to the other team.
Five Rams finish in double figures. Mandy McGurk leads the way with 14 points. With 13, it was Amy Hayford. 13 for Miranda Nyborg, 12 for Taylor Donaldson, and then 13 again for Matilda Flood. But that will do it from me and Chris here inside the Rose Hill Gym. Final score, Fordham 76, UMass Lowell 49. We'll send it back to our Rose Hill studios for the one-on-one post-game report with Chaz McAdams and Madi Dembele.
The one-on-one post-game report.
Welcome to the one-on-one post-game report. I'm Chaz McAdams in the Rose Hill Studios. Fordham Rams getting one over on the UMass Lowell Riverhawks, winning 76-49. A lot to talk, a lot of great things to talk about. This Rams squad dominated, especially in that second half. But first, we got one final scoreboard with my guy, Madi Dembele, kicking it over to him for the one-on-one scoreboard.
The one-on-one scoreboard.
Ladies and gentlemen, it's the last one of the day. Come with me, Madi Dembele, as I take you around the world of sports. Staying in the A-10, the Charlotte 49ers get it done against the George Washington Revolutionaries. They win 50-38. Expanding to women's basketball as a whole, the Lady Bruins perfect in their second of the back-to-back against the Purple Eagles as UCLA is dog-walking Niagara 50-16. The Paradise Gem is here, number 10 NC State, taking control of the number three ranked Colorado, 66-43. Everyone's favorite LSU Lady Tigers take on the Cavaliers in the Cayman Islands Classic today at 5. As we cross over, Euro step to the men's side, George Mason and East Carolina, interesting game there, as they are tied 26-all. The Missouri Tigers fend off the Loyola Maryland Greyhounds, they take the day 78-70. Roll Tide, the Alabama Crimson Tide take on the Oregon Ducks. Again, this is basketball, not football, later on today at 4. The Brooklyn Nets are in town to take on the Miami Heat, and the Philadelphia 76ers travel down to Oklahoma City to take on the Thunder. As we move to the gridiron, the game. Michigan, Ohio State, 24-17 in favor of Michigan. Get your popcorn. Watch now. For the one-on-one scoreboard, I am Madi Dembele.
Madi, fantastic as always.
Thank you, sir.
Always great to hear from you, my guy. Let's talk about those Rams, though, man.
Let's talk about it.
Well, 28-piece McNugget. Come on now. Almost 30-piecing the UMass Lowell Riverhawks, a team that is obviously weak. We know this.
Yeah.
Bottom of the America East, winless on the year, but a D1 team nonetheless, and to almost beat them by 30, I feel like Fordham is putting themselves back on the map.
You know, I got to eat crow a little bit here. I saw UMass Lowell trying to make a comeback. I was wrong. Like I said before that, like we said, strength in numbers for this Fordham Rams. How many starters, double digits? How many guys, double digits? 5. Lou Orlando, our producer, has his hands of 5. Matilda Flood, 13 points. Miranda Nyborg, I mean, she hit a beautiful, like, out of the post, like, bounce pass over to, I want to say it was Mandy McGurklick, just beautiful basketball all throughout. And their defense specifically, not just the offense, the defense, they forced some tough shots for UMass Lowell, air balls, shot clock violations. I mean, Fordham got it done on both sides of the ball.
Wild in their head.
Yeah.
I think UMass Lowell didn't know what they were getting into when they drove into the Bronx today, when they crossed the Cross Bronx Expressway. Shout out Robert Moses. They came in, I think, a little lackadaisical, which is a word that I love to play in Scrabble. When I look at this second half, we talked about the first half. What I saw in the second half is top 5 A-10 basketball, and I mean that. I really do think these Fordham Rams can get it done. Tilly Flood, 50-50-100 split. TD on her game back, first game back, 50-50-100 split. Manny McGurk, 14 off the bench, and she didn't even hit her threes. She didn't even hit her specialty.
Really,
she's still dropping 14?
The team as a whole shot 49.2% from the field as a whole.
Dogs. Miranda Nyborg.
Oh, my God.
Blocks? Kayla Harris and Amina Lee are out, so Miranda Nyborg says, I'm stepping into my role, and I'm going to get 4 blocks?
Yeah.
Miranda Nyborg can hoop. TD can hoop. Amy Hayford, probably the only dark spot we could say to this game, she was slightly inefficient. In the second half, she was over 40%, over 45% from the field.
Started off the half 2 or 3 from the field. Had a great steal to start off.
Exactly. She had a bad first quarter. I will say a bad first quarter. Stepped up huge in the other three. Didn't let it get in her head. Kayla Berry, 3 offensive boards. Cassie Mahaney getting into the fray a little bit. The way that these Rams played is how they, if they can continue to play at this level, they will do fantastic things in the A-10.
Which is really why
we're looking to conference.
Yeah, play. I really wasn't concerned about the first half because I know what this Fordham team does. And again, those scores there, you're going to hit your shots eventually. Again, you're getting great shots, as your coach said before the even broadcast started. You want to get the great shots. You're going to get the great shots. And eventually they'll start falling for guys like this. Matilda Flood towards the end. Lou Orlando, again, plugging Lou Orlando here for a second time. He mentioned how last time, the end of last season, Matilda Flood shot over 50% from three.
How cheap?
Back
half
of last season. People forget that Matilda Flood is playing the four and is probably more of a 2-3, but she has the defensive capability. She's the best defender on that squad.
Strong frame. She gets in their face. She's strong perimeter defender. She could defend out in space. She could protect the basket a little bit. Hit the three. She's fantastic.
I mean, you said dog walk in your scoreboard. I want to talk about a dog walk. How many assists did they have against Manhattan?
Three
assists as a squad. It was a rough game. How many tonight? 17?
17. Like many guys.
The mentality of a bounce back like this game, I don't even talk about Georgia in court because Fordham as a squad is so much above that. I mean, 40 pieces of 40 pieces.
Yeah, stuff like that happens.
But that's going to happen. That's what I expect. The ability for Fordham to bounce back after a pretty defeating loss like that says volumes about how this squad has changed their mentality since they played the Jaspers.
Yeah, it's a resilient squad indeed. And again, you're going to have losses on your schedule. Nobody's going to go perfect, or maybe they will. Who knows? But you're not going to go perfect. And as long as you keep winning the games that you're supposed to win, you take care of business here, and Fordham's golden. Like, this is a really, really good basketball team. And again, strength in numbers. They got so many guys off the bench. You saw so many people go down. Here comes the next guy. I mean, to have that many people in double digits, and to be that efficient as a team, I mean, it's something you could always, like, be happy about. And, of course, on the defensive end, which is something that the Fordham Rams always hang their hat on, is the strong defense or hard-nosed physical play. Worked out for them in the second half.
They might be the best man-to-man defense, person-to-person defense in the A-10. I'm talking about their man set.
Their man sets.
That is their favorite type of defense. Their zone is effective. It's able to fun into some strong bigs, but especially when you have Amina Lee and Kayla Harris out, the way that they can dodge screens, blow them up, that they ice,
versatile.
They hedge, the traps off of screens. Coach Bridgette Mitchell's been fantastic with implementing different defensive mindsets to put into her players' brains and how they're gonna be playing defense, the X's and O's way. The intangibles were there.
Yeah.
The drive was there. They just needed to refine it. Iron needed to sharpen iron a little bit.
Yeah. The defensive
28 piece win.
Yeah. The defensive schemes are absolutely awesome. It's almost like the defense is beating the offense to their spots. You mentioned again coming off of the pick and roll, the hedge, and how they're able to trap. They do that. It works so efficiently and it works so great. And again, it's even for a program that, again, hangs their hats on hard-nosed physical play, this is very, very impressive. And all these guys are versatile. They could guard, I think a majority of them could probably guard 1-4, 1-5, easy. No problem.
Manhattan UMass Lowell shot 9 free throws.
9 free throws, total.
Keeping the fouls to a minimum also, when you're playing such hard-nosed defense, when you're playing that, as Chris Carrino says, that tenacious kind of defense.
You're playing with a dangerous line.
But 9 free throws is not bad for 40 minutes of regulation basketball. I'm hesitant to say proud to kind of separate myself from this squad, but a bounce back like I've never seen before.
Impressed.
I think Manhattan is bad enough to be comp to UMass Lowell.
Yeah.
And I mean, I'm thoroughly, thoroughly impressed with the way that the Fordham Rams have been able to pick themselves up by their bootstraps and just say, I'm not going to go down without a fight. And they didn't go down at all.
Never
given up a lead.
And not to bring this into boxing, but usually there's a phrase in boxing. This is old boxing wisdom. It's not just who you face. It's how you beat them as well. You could face a scrub or a guy who has a bad record, but if you knock him out in a sensational fashion, it's just like, oh, my God. Fordham is playing the correct temperature of defense as of right now. Again, they're playing aggressive defense, but they're not fouling. And the offense is clicking right now. This is exactly what you want to see if you're Bridgette Mitchell and this Fordham Rams unit. I have no complaints. I have no beef.
I couldn't put it better myself. I mean, a fantastic win. Yeah. To say I don't think they could have gotten a better win out of this squad if they had tried. TD's back. Amina Lee and Kayla Harris are going to be back soon.
The momentum.
Squad's not even at full health.
Not even.
Carry momentum in a conference play going into the holiday season. I'm very, very pleased.
Yeah.
Looking ahead, not to specific games yet, but looking, what are every game, win or loss, what are lessons that you can learn from this game?
I mean, what you're good at. You stick to your strengths and you see what happens. I mean, going back to the other game, Georgian court, they beat them, what, 85-44?
Oh, my God. That was awesome. I was there courtside. That was awesome.
Awesome. I bet it was.
Cass Mahaney, like, getting 14, like, giving her flowers. Killer.
Yep, and that's coming off of a two-game losing streak. Now you're on a two-game win streak. That's coming off a two-game losing streak. You're coming off a two-game win streak now. You're going to take on St. Peter's, I believe, the 28th, which is a Tuesday.
Mm-hmm, night
and,
game.
Yeah, and then you got your guys returning. Let's see how you prepare against that unit there. But Fordham has everything to be proud of. You're clicking with your guys coming back. I mean, what else can you ask for?
I mean, it's St. Peter's, Maine, and then we get right into – or St. Peter's, Maine, then Duquesne. I love rhyming. Wow, St. Peter's, Maine, then Duquesne. Looking ahead in the next week or two, then it's Siena, Fairfield, and UVA. Who's UVA is tough. They UVA play them on December 21st. But you only got a handful of non-conference left, and I mean, if trajectory can speak for itself, I think when you go into that first game, December 30th against St. Joe's, for some reason, I think you might want to tune into that one, especially I think Lou Orlando is going to agree with that. That St. Joe's game is going to be must-listen radio. I think you're on the up-and-up textbook. You look up-and-up in the colloquialism dictionary, and it's Rose Hill getting an offensive – it's Rose Nelson getting an offensive rebound.
Like, you want to talk offensive rebound? Fordham had how many on the day? 11?
11. Dog.
11.
Second chance point. That's what we're saying. So the offense is clicking in the sets. And when it's not, they're there to get the second chance points.
Yeah, everything's
no complaints. Chef's kiss. Mwah.
From top to bottom, the second half was a complete night and day difference from the first half. I mean, offensive rebounds 11-7. Defensive rebounds 26-22. Assists 17-9. Turnovers, you're keeping it less, 13-20. I mean, everything. You're controlling the pace exactly how you want it to be. I mean,
and Coach B with the realistic expectations, talking about the turnover threshold, not saying we're going to try to get sub 10 turnovers coming off of that tough game against the Jaspers, where they had 21, dropping it to 13.
They will happen. Beautiful. Turnovers
are going to happen. It's basketball, right? Game of runs. Turnovers will happen.
Yeah.
If you can just minimize them to a level where you feel good about how you played in that game, I think a lot of teams wrote them off, wrote the Fordham Rams off. The Fordham Rams didn't write back.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying?
I like that one. That's a good one, Chaz.
I think URI, UMass Amherst, Duquesne, Davidson, they're all.
You have company. It's a popcorn.
They're back on the Fordham Rams are now highlighted on the calendar.
Yes, I mean,
that was a fantastic win.
You have to game plan for this Fordham Rams unit. They have everybody back. Get your popcorn.
And they're not even full health.
Not even at full health.
One big all day. And she didn't even play that much. They ran a small ball lineup, which they didn't even spam feed Miranda Nyborg in the post, which she's so good at scoring. Her post moves, her pivots.
She has the baby jump hook, as we said before.
Gorgeous. And she's got that nice little mid-range. Yeah. She's 5-for-6 from the line. They shot great from the line today, 9-for-12.
Yeah.
If this Fordham Rams team can continue this upward trajectory, this upward momentum like a rocket ship, take note, A-10. All I'm saying, get us back on your calendar. It's no days off when you're coming to the Bronx, or the Bronx is coming to you. Final thoughts, Madi.
I mean, again, I'm just proud of the second half. Again, everything that we wanted to happen happened. We said take care of the basketball. What do they go out and do? They get proper sets in, and they don't try to rush anything. The defense turns up in the second half. They're getting steals left and right. They're forcing 24-second violations, air balls even. I mean, this looks like it was just a better, cleaner basketball product towards the end. And I have no beef. Again, if Fordham plays like that with their guys coming back, again, teams are going to have to circle them on their calendar when they go and they game plan for the Fordham Rams. So,
Chaz McAdams, all gas, no breaks, player of the game. It's a award I just made up on the spot right now. Goes to Matilda Flood, 13 points on 50-50-100 splits.
Absolutely.
6 rebounds with 3 O boards.
Two big threes, two steals,
and a block. 2 huge threes to end the game. It's been fantastic. The engineer has been Andres Rodriguez, my guy Lou Orlando, on the ones and twos. Nick Guzman and Chris Carrino did a great job.
Yes, they did.
WFUV Sports coordinators, Bobby Chaffredini. For Madi Dembele, I'm Chaz McAdams. This has been a production of WFUV Sports.